Sean Hannity. Mike, this is the first time I've ever called you, and I'm glad to be listening to you every day right after the Don and Mike show. And
thank
I
you.
Just think that you would make a perfect guest on their show.
Tell Don and Mike, anytime they want me, I'd be glad to come. Hello.
Don and Mike, there'll be no mollycoddling.
You see if your mom can give my resume to Dennis Phillips? Because if I could get in a Broadway show, then I would have done it all. Film, television, and theater.
The only thing left to be radio. That's just for ugly people.
This episode deals with the inappropriateness of racial invectives and contains coarse racial slurs. Viewer discretion is advised.
Everybody loves Dynamite.
And yes, the rumors are true. They smoke, they drink, they use bad language in mixed company. They're extremely rich and they can flash more bling than most posses in this room. Rock stars they are, and God bless them for that.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
Stop on the rock.
Woo!
Stop on the rock.
Woo!
Stop on the rock. Can't stop the rock. You can't stop.
What's
going
on
over
there?
I've had it up to here with the likes of you people.
Hey, Howard, there's your Chinaman.
Oh, thanks, Fred.
Hi, Don.
Today, unfortunately, my son walked in right on the very unintended tail end of that.
Yeah, I didn't mean for that to happen. I wanted to finish before he got here.
Bart, let me ask you, or maybe you didn't see. You didn't see the sodomy today?
No.
What?
Oh, no, thank God.
Good. You didn't see Buzz sodomizing me?
Thank God, no.
Well, anyway, he did. And today, the item of choice was?
Today, it was a number three pencil.
That's why I barely fell down there. It was like, a feather.
A fine point.
Should he use the number two?
Anyway, he did all of that. Thanks for the beverage, Mike. He did all of that so that I would announce his name, Buzz Girdley.
Thank
Buzz
you.
Girdley.
It worked.
And welcome to a show that, frankly, I don't know if anybody's going to listen to.
Well, sometimes you got to just throw up things and see what sticks to the wall.
Now, today, we got a lot of stuff. We got a lot of show stuff. We got Craig Wilson today.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to pick the Las Vegas-style show winner for Philadelphia today.
That's good.
We've got Shaq and Dennis dialing for gays today.
Fantastic.
But it is it's an exciting day on the Don and Mike show, because today
it's for me.
We're having like our first ever on-air fantasy draft.
Woo!
Uncle Mike is mixing the beverages.
Hold on.
And let me introduce you to the players today. Of course, you have me, Don, and then everybody's favorite, Mike.
Hi, everybody.
And you have Robay Spiewak.
Hi, Robay. Hi, Robay.
Then you have Lisa Herndon. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Hello.
And then you have Charlie Broyhill.
Hi.
Our production man, Johnny, mm-hmm. Johnny Norman.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello.
Hi, Charlie.
Guy Birdley.
Hi.
Hi, Mike.
And Bart Source.
Hi, Bart.
And
hi, Charlie.
Welcome to the show. Now we're going to get right underway with round number one.
Ah.
Okay. Mike, I know you're mixing drinks and stuff.
See, once again, I'm at a disadvantage.
But,
you were late.
But we're going to get right to it.
Not late.
You should have been in here to start that sooner.
I was not late, you wipe.
I did tell it to start mixing earlier.
See? I was waiting because the only thing I didn't have was cups. And
right.
Guess who I asked to go get
yeah.
them? Guess who I asked to get the cups?
Joseph Ardinger.
Thank you.
Now, here are the rules.
How do you like your beverage?
It's mighty tasty.
Thank you.
Mighty tasty. We have how many rounds, Robay?
16
rounds.
16.
It'll just fly.
16 rounds.
Yeah.
Well, I think the first couple of rounds will fly.
We're doing in a minute. Is you guys are going to be amazed at how quick
right.
it goes.
I don't think most people will need 1 minute to take their first selection.
No. It depends on where you are.
God, I hope not. Let me see. I do have the TikTok. The TikToks.
Yeah.
I do have the. Where's the sound when someone actually makes a pick? There we go.
La, 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 la.
That will slow down. There you go. And I've got the beautiful NFL music.
Yeah,
all
please,
kinds good. Of NFL music. So, let me just say, without further ado, on the clock now, with the first pick in the Don and Mike Fantasy League.
Exciting, isn't it?
Here is. Buzz Burbank.
For our first pick, the Buzz Burbank anchors choose running back Marshall Faulk.
Marshall Faulk goes to Buzz. Marshall Faulk is off the board.
Yes, he is.
You have put me in a bad, bad place, Buzz.
I'm sorry. I actually thought that would help you out. I thought that would open up somebody else for you.
That's who I wanted, though. Marshall Faulk.
Only I. Who drafts two? As soon as the next first pick's made, the next person's on the clock.
He's got a minute.
Okay, I'd say he's about 20 seconds into it.
I choose Kurt Warner.
Oh, shocker.
There
surprise
it is.
Of surprise.
Kurt Warner. That is my selection. That means we go to number three, and that would be Bart Source.
Taking my minute.
Right. Good, good, Bart. I think that's smart. I think this steamrolling right to the...
Gives Rob a chance to catch up.
Gives Mike a chance to look at his list. Now, Bart, do you have your pick?
I'm thinking.
Because really, it would help old dad's show if you would you'd make that pick.
Well, if you wanted it to be 30 seconds, Max, you should have made
there you go. I agree with your son, as I always do.
Love you dearly, Dad, but I have a minute.
All right, you do have a minute. And I guess you're going to take every second of that minute.
How you been, Bart?
Excuse me, Bart.
Bart. Doing well.
Now, Bart, you're not even
do that to us.
You're not even looking at your list.
I'm looking directly.
All right, please. Who's your pick?
Amon Green.
Amon Green of the Green Bay Packers off the board. And that means on the board now, with the number four pick, is Tex O'Meara.
This is going to be a good pick.
Here you go, Tex. Now, you got plenty of good players to choose from.
It is Serena Williams.
Look at him going through his papers.
Dan Humphries?
Ted Williams?
I'm going to make my pick.
As Sam Huff.
Going to go with Sean Alexander.
Sean Alexander of the Seattle Seahawks. That is Mike's pick, Sean Alexander. Who's on the clock now?
Hi.
Lisa Herndon. Lisa with 60 seconds to make her first round pick. As we wait on Lisa, hope she's faster with this than she is with the Amtrak decision.
What?
Make your pick, please, darling. Dear.
Hello, dear.
Hello, dear.
Jeff Garcia.
Jeff Garcia. Talks like a fag, but he sure can throw the ball. Jeff Garcia is off the board. And the next pick belongs to?
That'd be me, Don.
That would
John,
be
Jonathan
Johnny.
Norman.
Johnny Norman.
One of my good pals. One of the guys that I'd like to see win this league if it's not going to be me.
Johnny.
It's not going to be you, Mike.
Just the way I feel about the boy. Okay, that's enough goodwill from you.
Johnny. Johnny?
Yeah.
An important decision.
Give me Donovan McNabb.
Donovan McNabb. Donovan McNabb is off the board. Mm-hmm. We now go to Robe Speed Bump. Thank you, Mike.
That wasn't me.
That was me.
Oh, Charlie.
Yeah, my fruit.
Randy Moss.
Randy Moss.
Wow.
Rob breaking the cardinal rule.
I knew there'd be one.
Randy Moss.
That would probably be the only black guy on Rob's team. Now with pick number 8 and pick number 9, here is Carlos Broyhill.
I have 2 minutes, don't I?
You do.
You do.
I'm still trying to find Randy Moss.
1 minute to wait, make one pick, and then 1 minute. Peyton Manning and Marvin Harrison.
Oh, I hate you.
Bastard.
I hate you, I hate you, I hate you.
Bastard, bastard, bastard. And that means we go now to Robe Spiewak.
Harrison and, man.
Robe Spiewak. On the clock.
I would take Dante Culpepper.
Dante Culpepper. Hey, Rob, showing some knowledge. Dante Culpepper. And now we go to Johnny Norman.
I'll take Ricky Williams.
Ricky Williams. All right, everybody's scratching to put the name off the list.
Trying to.
And that means next we go to Lily.
No.
Who you like, Lily?
Terrell Owens.
Terrell Owens. What a smart pick. And as we continue, we then go to Bart.
Brett.
Oh, I'm sorry, Uncle Mike. Uncle Mike is next. Uncle Mike.
Brett Favre.
God, food.
Thank you, Bart.
I hope you get gonorrhea.
Now, you mean you hope you can cure gonorrhea? He's already got it. And Bart, as a matter of fact, we've all got it. That means if I've got it, you got it. Who's your pick, son?
Now I have to take my minute.
All right, take your minute.
Dick. You're going to hear a lot of that.
Where's Brett Favre on my overall list?
You didn't really want him.
Huh?
You didn't really want him.
No, I
didn't.
You only took him because Bart wanted him.
Well, and also my conversation with you yesterday, you kind of sold me, even though he's been downgraded on my little internet site.
Bart. Bart.
He's good. Can we pass over him?
Gannon.
Who?
Gannon.
Richard Gannon.
Gannon.
Rich Gannon.
Stupid horse.
You told
you
were going
to pick quarterback last.
Which means it's to me.
Knew you were.
To me, Rich Gannon, Rich Gannon. Christ.
Where the hell is he?
Ah, there he is on the list. Okay, I will have to take Torrey Holt.
It begins.
Torrey Holt.
He's going to get Isaac Bruce, too.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he is.
I picked before him.
Why, you wouldn't do that to me, Charlie.
Oh, no, never.
Let's go to Buzz.
You got Rich Gannon? Somebody get Rich Gannon?
Yeah.
My next pick, quarterback Drew Bledsoe. Now, he's being mocked. He's supposed to have a good year with Buffalo. They're laughing.
You laugh now. Yes.
Hey, Buzz?
They laughed at the guy who invented the airplane. Thank you.
So it's my pick, right?
No, it's
no.
That's number 13 on my list.
Who's next?
It should be Buzz again.
Buzz again.
Doubles back.
He wasn't ready yet.
Okay, for my next choice, I choose the Packers defense.
Okay, now I'm going to
the Packers defense.
All right. Okay, can't support you there, pal.
It's all right.
The
we'll
Packers
see.
Defense.
Anything can happen.
That's right.
And it's me now? It's me now?
Yes, sir.
Isaac defense. Bruce?
Isaac Bruce. Look at this. Hold on. Look at this mock draft that I put right there. Top 3 picks.
You got him. Main crash.
Got him. And now we go to Uncle Mike.
It's no.
Bart. I'm sorry, Bart.
David Boston.
David Boston of Phoenix. Good pick.
Arizona.
Sorry.
All right.
I'm old school. And now we go to Uncle Mike.
All right, hold on. All right, hold on.
They started in Chicago.
The Cardinals.
Right.
I'm aware of that. And they stopped in St. Louis in between.
Okay.
Known briefly as the Phoenix Cardinals.
Right.
Before they were known as the Arizona Cardinals.
Has anyone taken the Packers defense yet?
Yes. Yes, they have. So there. Jay Fiedler.
Okay.
Jew. Pointing it out that Mike has a Jewish quarterback. Number five would be Lisa. I've doubled the intensity. That was a premature buzz. Lisa.
Priest Holmes.
Priest Holmes.
Good pick.
Is he Catholic?
Priest Holmes. And we now go to John Norman.
Yeah.
Help yourself, son.
John Norman's up.
Keyshawn Johnson.
Keyshawn is early gone on this board. Keyshawn Johnson, which means we go to Robe Speed Bump.
Curtis Martin.
Curtis Martin, my favorite Martin.
I like Dean.
Your favorite Martin. My favorite Martin.
Yeah. Stole that from, what's his name, Chris Berman.
My favorite Martin. Bank, 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 bank.
With the next two picks, Carlos Broyhill. This is actually moving very fast.
Mm-hmm.
We're doing a pretty good job on this.
Me one pick. Me throw feces.
Edgerrin James.
There you go. And Edgerrin James.
Rod Smith.
Rod, so you son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. John Norman. Glad that I wanted Rod Smith.
I know you didn't.
But I did. It's John's pick, right?
Rob. Oh. 1 second. 1 minute. Plenty of time. That was
my
time.
Never a minute.
That was
premature. That was Charlie's 2 minutes. So, John, now you're operating at less than 2 minutes.
That's me.
Oh, it's Rob. Sorry, Rob. Whatever.
Just pick.
Rob.
Tony Gonzalez.
He signed it?
Tony Gonzalez. That is the pick. Tony Gonzalez, holdout.
He's playing basketball this year, I think.
And now it's John Norman, right?
Yes.
John Norman.
Johnny Norman. Johnny Norman picking all his players.
Johnny.
Johnny Norman, king of the wild frontier. He's Johnny. Johnny Norman. Whoa, having some fun on draft day.
Thanks, Mike. Can I get one of those?
During the break.
I'll take LaDainian Tomlinson, please.
LaDainian Tomlinson from San Diego.
A fine running back from the San Diego Chargers.
Like you have a clue.
Yeah, well, I'm prepared today.
Lisa. Lily. Lee. Lee. Sheely.
Feely.
Lee Lee Herndon. Demolition driver.
Nope.
Lover of everything black.
What's your pick, dear?
Tens of thousands of men.
Tens of thousands of black men. Who are you picking? Lisa?
Corey Dillon.
Corey Dillon.
With confidence.
Corey Dillon.
Damn it.
And that means Mike O'Mara is on the board.
God, I hate it when somebody picks my player right before me.
Yeah.
Hello.
Ha. You did it to Bart.
Ha.
I did.
Yeah.
Yes, you did.
Indeed.
So, Mike?
I'm going to go with Anthony Thomas.
From the Bears?
Yep.
Anthony Thomas. Out of there. Bart.
Yeah.
You're on the clock, Bart.
Okay.
Bart Source.
I heard you.
My son.
Yes, sir.
The man, the legend.
Tim Brown.
Tim Brown of the Raiders. Tim Brown. And that would be to me. Ah, oh, to me.
Anybody left on the Rams team?
To me. Wow, I got a whole bunch of guys I want. Christ. Will they be available later? You have a prediction, Charlie? I'm not going to take the Rams defense this high.
Oh, you're not?
No, I'm not. Ed McCaffrey.
I was wrong.
You're a J for Ed McCaffrey.
Denver. And Buzz.
For my next pick, running back Ricky Williams.
Already gone.
That's taken, and I'll make
it.
That
was going to happen. I knew you'd be the first one to do that.
Yeah, there are a couple I missed, but then I'll try Steven Davis, please.
Steven Davis?
Yeah.
And you get another pick.
Okay, let's make it. Was Terrell Owens taken yet?
Yes.
David Boston?
Yes.
Terry Glenn, then.
Terry Glenn of the Green Bay Packers. All right, so that puts me back on the clock. Notice I don't slow the show down. St. Louis Rams defense and special teams. And we go to...
That basket's full of the same eggs.
Barry.
I was in my pick already. Oh.
Right, one, two, three.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I was premature.
Okay.
You have 25 seconds left.
Good.
Did you just pick the St. Louis defensive team?
Yes.
I'll take Michael Bennett.
Of the Vikings. Michael Bennett off the board, and that means we go to Tex O'Mara.
Dwayne Bates.
Who?
Dwayne Bates.
Of who?
Sleeper.
Minnesota Vikings.
A wide receiver.
Yes, wide receiver.
Wide receiver. Pick number five belongs to Lili.
What was Bates' first name?
Dwayne with a D. D apostrophe W-A-Y-N-E.
Dwayne.
Dwayne.
I don't care about Dwayne Bates.
Dwayne. Lili.
Steelers defense.
Steelers defense off the board. And that means we go now to Johnny Norman. Johnny Norman.
Choice between two. I will take the unhappy Aaron Brooks.
Aaron Brooks. He's cursed. Take it from me. Had him last year.
He's a bad guy.
Now, you want to get yourself one of those voodoo dolls. Rob Speedbump.
Chicago defense.
Chicago!
Chicago!
And then Carlos Broyhill, two in a row.
Antoine Smith and Cordell Stewart.
Antoine Smith of the Patriots, Cordell Stewart of the Steelers. And we are back to John Norman. Rob, sorry. Robe.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
What do you think our rating is right now?
0.00, Mr. Pitarski.
Can you have negative numbers?
Rob?
Brian Greasy.
Lisa, you took the Chicago defensive team, didn't you?
Negative.
Anybody take Chicago's defense?
Yes, they're gone.
Rob, who did you just pick?
Ryan Greasy.
And that means now it's John Norman. Realize how annoying this sound is.
I love it.
The silence or the TikTok?
The TikTok. See, we're all very serious about this.
Oh, yes.
I got to take Eddie George.
Eddie George, that's a good pick. And next would be Lily. Oh, sorry.
So you pick Eddie George?
Yep.
It's going fast. Starting to lose my place.
Yeah. We are in round, what is this, round six?
Anybody take Deuce McAllister yet?
Nope.
Nope.
He's all here.
Good to have him. But wait, he'll be there. Lisa.
Four bottles.
Joe Horn.
Joe Horn. Joe Little Big Horn. Two, Uncle Mike.
Jeremy Shockey.
You know what? That big dummy wouldn't even have known about Jeremy Shockey if I hadn't told you yesterday. You violated a code.
And what was the one reason that would cause me to violate the code?
Are you drinking?
No, the hat that he's wearing.
The Giants hat? I know. F you.
Just made him think of it. He probably forgot until this morning.
Hmm?
You probably forgot all about Jeremy Shockey.
We had this conversation yesterday.
I wasn't there for it, dick.
During the commercials, Mike says to me, who do you like? Who's your sleeper? I said, it's tight end for the Giants.
I also watched, over the weekend, I watched a little profile on Jeremy Shockey. They had a little feature on the guy, so I knew who I was drafting.
Is he upset about his dad dying?
Who?
Did his dad die?
Yeah, his dad
just
sick.
They were talking about him being a...
Just jockey. Shockey. It's Shockey, not Chockey.
I was thinking of Dick Shaq.
Bart.
I love it when you try comedy.
It's just above our heads. It's actually quite funny.
Bart, you're up.
Marcus Pollard still on the board?
Uh-huh.
Yep.
I'll take him.
Marcus Pollard. And that means to me... You're a bastard.
I love it. I screwed his draft.
You really are. Bubba Franks.
Oh, that's who I wanted.
Green Bay. Buzz.
Michael Vick.
All right.
And Buzz again.
Joe Horn was taken, right?
Yes.
That's a yes. Rod Smith. Okay,
yes.
Daryl Jackson, then.
Who?
Daryl Jackson with the Saints?
Yeah. That must be the one.
Seattle, right.
Seattle.
Okay.
Yeah, him too.
So back to me. And Michael Pittman. Tampa Bay. Running back. To Bart.
I thought you were going to play that sounder after every pick.
Oh, right. Forgot about it. Oh, sorry.
I like that.
Well, we're moving so fast without it, Rob.
It is. It's moving
so fast, I'm starting to lose my place.
I'll take Jake Plummer.
Jake? The snake.
Much better.
Well, laugh loud.
Do you like your job?
No.
Don't forget you can't spell smart ass without ASS.
Watch it, Al.
You may leave.
May I?
Mike.
Larry.
Team O'Mara.
Mike.
Hold on.
Moma.
Hold on.
Team Mike O'Mara.
Hold on right now.
Mike.
Hines Ward.
Pittsburgh.
What position?
Wide receiver. And that means we go to Lily. Lily. And I think after we get done with the first half of the draft, we'll break. Uh-huh. It'll allow folks to call in and critique our picks.
I expect nothing but praise for mine.
Waiting on Lisa.
I come here often. Normally my breakfast is great.
Lisa?
Jimmy Smith.
James Smith, Jacksonville Jaguars.
There goes Jimmy Smith. He'd been sitting there a while.
Yeah.
That guy's caused me a lot of hurt over the years, Lisa.
That would be John Norman. Johnny N.
We'll
keep spinning.
No suspense here. We'll go with Eric Moulds.
Eric Moulds, Buffalo Bills. To Rob Speed Bump.
Shannon Shire.
Shannon Sharp. And if Charlie takes this pick, is that the end of the eighth round?
Seventh
round? Then we're almost more than halfway through.
Wow.
No, we've done great.
Just almost half.
All right, then we got to do one more then to be right. Halfway through. Charlie, so take two picks. Carlos Broyhill, everybody. What?
I don't know if I want him. Yes, I do. Jerome Bettis.
That's a pick from the heart. That's not a brain pick. That's a heart pick.
That's right.
And?
Just waiting for the bus.
Oh, Jerome Bettis. Your 2 minutes are up.
Mike Vanderjack.
Kicker. First kicker taken. And? Oh, Mike Vanderjack. Gentlemen, we now begin the final round before commercial break, the halfway mark, and we go to John, Rob, Robay,
Derek Mason.
And now John Norman's on the clock. Johnny.
Troy Brown.
Arbitrar just called to ask if we're still on the air today.
They sent a sympathy card.
Troy Brown. Now it's to Lily.
Lisa.
Lisa. Lady Moola.
Esling.
Lisa.
Oh.
Need a pick.
Would you?
Steve McNair.
Bart Source.
No. You are Mike.
Oh, Mike O'Mara. Sorry.
Hey.
Mike.
Hey, is this all on the up and off?
Mike.
You'll be sorry, Pee Wee Herman. Jason Elam.
Kicker, Denver Broncos. Now, from my own demon seed, Bart.
Plaxico Burress.
Burress.
Who the hell is that?
Wide receiver.
Who does he play for?
Steelers.
All right.
I don't like his name.
I don't either.
To me.
Makes me angry.
Keenan McCardell, Tampa Bay. And finally, ending out. Oh, excuse me.
What was your pick?
Keenan McCardell. And winding out the halfway point of the draft, Buzz Burbank.
Tight end Ernie Conwell.
Ladies and gentlemen, and having only taken up nearly a half hour of the show, we are done with more than half of the draft.
Yay!
Now, does everybody have their teams written down?
So far, so good.
Yeah. Everybody know their teams?
Yeah.
Buzz, yes, who have you selected?
So far, Marshall Faulk, the Packers defense. Let's see who else. I have Steven Davis. I have Terry Glenn. I have Daryl Jackson. I have Ernie Conwell. Those are my picks so far.
I have Kurt Warner, Torrey Holt, Isaac Bruce, Michael Pittman, Ed McCaffrey, Rams defense, and Bubba Franks. Bart.
I have Rich Gannon, Jake Plummer, Amon Green, Michael Bennett, David Boston, Tim Brown, Plaxico Burress, and Marcus Pollard.
Uncle Mike.
I have, for my quarterbacks, Brett Favre and Jay Fiedler, running backs Sean Alexander and Anthony Thomas, wide receivers Dwayne Bates and Hines Ward, tight end Jeremy Shockey of your New York Giants, and kicker Jason Elam.
Lele.
Quarterbacks Jeff Garcia and Steve McNair, Running backs, Priest Holmes and Corey Dillon. Wide receivers, Terrell Owens, Joe Horn, Jimmy Smith, and the Pittsburgh defense.
And John Norman.
Oh, Donovan McNabb, Ricky Williams, Keyshawn Johnson, LaDainian Tomlinson, Aaron Brooks, Eddie George, Eric Molds, and Troy Brown. That's who it is.
Rob Speedbump.
Dante Culpepper, Brian Greasy, Curtis Martin, Tony Gonzalez, Shannon Sharp, Chicago defense, Randy Moss, and Derek Mason.
And Carlos.
Peyton Manning, Cordell Stewart, Edgerrin James, Jerome Bettis, Antoine Smith, Marvin Harrison, Rod Smith, and Mike Vanderjagt.
What was that last name?
Vanderjagt.
Okay. Get some constructive criticism. Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I don't know if I'm a loser or just a big fan of football, but I've been following the whole thing, writing down everyone's pick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
And I think Lisa's team looks really good, actually.
Hey, how about that, Lisa?
Hey, go Lisa.
Right.
And Charlie, actually, I'm sorry to say, his team looks pretty good, too.
His team always looks
always
good.
Always does.
You know, I listened to him read that all-star team that he had. It sounded pretty good.
Mine ain't bad.
Yeah, I know.
Don, yours looks good. You got a lot of St. Louis guys.
A lot of St. Louis guys, right.
You're doing that strategy where you go for one team.
That's right.
He gives up on the bye week.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
So that's one loss.
Right.
That's one week I know I'm going to lose. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, I just want to tell them who is going to win this league.
You're on the air. Go ahead.
Turn your radio down.
I apologize.
Okay.
Charlie will win this league.
I'm used to that. Thank you, sir.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, what's up?
Does no one want to comment on Buzz?
Yeah. What's
Hello?
Up with that?
Don and Mike. Hello.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
How's it going?
Come on, what do you think?
I think Buzz takes absolutely blow. Sorry,
Thank
Buzz.
You. Thank you.
Okay.
I have a question about that. I only have 6 picks so far. Everybody else has 8. Did I get
Buzz,
missed?
You have 8. Someone?
Really?
You have 8.
Wow, I've lost 2 already.
All right. Buzz.
What does he have?
Buzz has and quarterback Drew Bledsoe and Michael Vick.
Right.
At running back, you have Marshall Faulk and Steven Davis.
Right.
At tight ends.
Y.A. Tittle.
Ernie Conwell at
yeah,
tight end.
Right.
Do you remember your defense?
Yeah, I was the Packers.
Right, and wide receiver Terry Glenn and Daryl Jackson.
There you go. Okay,
That's
thanks.
It.
Hello, Don and Mike.
I have three roto teams. I've been listening the whole time, and Lisa's team is solid from top to bottom, just like Lisa.
These are all guys that just want to get in your pants, I think.
Bad.
Repeat your team again. Who do you have again?
Jeff Garcia, Steve McNair, Priest Holmes, Corey Dillon, Terrell Owens, Joe Horn, Jimmy Smith, and the Pittsburgh defense.
All right, not bad. Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, what's up, Don?
Hey.
Hey, actually, the way you guys are picking is, how are you guys picking, you know, you'll pick, like, a Peyton Manning and an Edgerrin James and a Marvin Harrison. How do you guys do that? That's, like, one of the rules of fantasy football, that you don't do that.
That's one of the great things about this league. You can do that.
You can. So what's the problem?
That means you got to root for that specific team. Like,
correct.
You got to spread it out.
No. See, Charlie and I both adhere to that policy. Charlie's putting a lot of his eggs into the Colts basket.
Oh, you guys are doing that on purpose.
Yeah, and I'm purposely picking all these St. Louis Rams guys.
Oh, okay.
And what I'm doing is I'm basing my entire team around my tight end this year.
Hello. Don and Mike Show.
Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, I just want to know how much crack Buzz was smoking this morning.
Not enough, apparently.
Other than his first pick, he might as well pick him out of a hat.
Yeah, well, as I explained yesterday, I don't care about the game. I know nothing about the game. I'm doing this because we're doing
you
this.
You have to.
Hello, right. Don and Mike.
I think
kind of like every day when you come to work, huh, pal?
Hello.
I think before anybody comments on the picks, we have to know, like, what the scoring is in the league. Like, how...
I'm sorry, I'm getting very obnoxious. I don't know why.
It's because you're drinking.
Having
a nice big BM. It's a passing league.
It's mainly like...
We haven't set up all the scoring yet. We're going to go in after we get done today and put in gradations for yards rushing, yards passing, yards receiving, and things of that nature. But right now, we just got, you know, the basic setup with touchdowns and field goals and extra points and stuff like that.
Hello, Donna Mike Show.
Yeah, Lili by far has the best picks. I put a grand for charity up against any of the teams that you guys got. She's going to kill
you
guys.
At this point, I don't think it's guys wanting to get in her pants. I think that really she has picked some good players.
Hi, Donna Mike Show.
Donna Mike.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Okay.
Buzz, I don't know what you're smoking. Don, you didn't do too well. You didn't do too well, Don, either.
Why?
You know, I'd like somebody to comment on me.
Hold on. How can you not do well when you have Kurt Warner, Torrey Holt, and Isaac Bruce?
Exactly. You're going to have absolutely no running back. You're not going to do. And you picked Hines Ward.
Hey, hello.
You picked Hines Ward.
Hold on.
I picked Hines Ward.
Douche, I didn't pick Hines Ward.
Oh.
And incidentally.
And what's wrong with Hines Ward?
And
Hines
also,
Ward is terrible.
Let me tell you something else. I won't pick another running back the whole rest of the way. Because in our league, you get 10 points if the running back gets 100 yards. There are not a lot of guys that get 100 yards. There are like four or five guys in the league that do that.
Okay.
Okay? So I took one guy, Michael Pittman, who I think might score some TDs for Tampa Bay.
He might do all right.
Does Hines Ward suck?
Hines Ward is, where'd you pick him? What round?
The last round, I think.
No,
the second to last round.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Their number one receiver.
Hello,
Don. He's not their number one receiver.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
No.
I think right now, with the way the picks are now,
don't know
a lot of callers are forgetting that there's a second round where things can change. Charlie and Lisa are running for
serious business, man.
Well, listen, hold on. This tells me that some people are actually listening to the show today.
That's good. Honor and privilege, sir.
Don, you're a sleeper. And Buzz, you're just an ass.
F you, sir.
Now. Hello, Don and Mike. Show.
Buzz, you taking a little
Don
heat
Mike,
today.
What's
yeah,
up,
I'm going to take a lot
hey,
of it.
Hey, my friend.
Hey, what's up with Washington defense, man? You got a stack of Pro Bowlers. Who's got Washington D?
Nobody
yet.
Still out there, my friend. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Buzz's got the sleeper pick of the draft so far with Drew Bledsoe. He's going to light it up this year with Eric Maltz.
Right.
People, so
hold
that.
On.
Everyone, please. Important thing here, everyone. One stalk of celery to a person.
Don and Mike, hello.
I haven't even got a drink yet.
Hello.
Buzz, I'll light you up right now.
Okay. Don and Mike.
Hey, I'm calling to support Buzz.
Why?
Yeah, why? What the hell's wrong with you, sir?
I feel his pain.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Am I the only one who thinks Buzz has made good picks?
Yes. Hello.
Yes, you are.
Hey, guys.
What a great guy he is. Hello.
Hey, guys. It's going great, but I just got to say, you never miss a jump split.
Right. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, Buzz is doing fine.
Thank you.
What are you smoking?
Drew Bledsoe is going to... When was he injured before last year? And I don't see any of you guys taking Tom Brady.
Tom Brady?
Tom Brady.
Yeah, that's what about right. that? Drew Bledsoe's terrible. Yeah, Tom Brady.
Here's the story. But a man named Brady.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Who would lose a lot of games for his team.
Hello.
Hey, is this the sports line?
Don't get out of here. We do this once a year. Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don, you left out the best running back. What's going on?
Who's that?
On.
Fred Lane, Carolina Panthers. Your sure shot running back.
Oh, that's the dead guy we were trying to think of yesterday. Fred Lane. Now listen.
You never miss a jump split.
Don and Mike, hello. Hello.
Hello.
You're on
hello?
The air.
Yeah, and how can you pick Ed McCaffrey so high when he's coming off a season where he busts his leg in like three complete pieces?
It's called GFG. Gift from God.
Well,
it would have to be.
Let's come on in here and get your beverage.
Yes, it would have to be. Don and Mike Show. Hello.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hi there.
Hey, Buzz.
Oh, he's coming in here to get his Bloody Mary.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
I really think you've done, for not knowing anything about the game, not caring about the game, you're doing a good job.
Well, F you. F you.
F me hard.
F you.
We love you, Buzz.
I don't love you, sir.
I will F you need to be F.
Okay, goodbye.
I don't love you.
Hello, Don and Mike. Hello.
Hello.
Don and Mike.
Radio God.
Hi there.
Buzz,
yes.
Your picks are great. Phenomenal. I love them. You're the underdog, baby.
You
can do it.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that.
Every stoner in the world's calling in right now.
Got any weed?
Hello, Don and Mike.
Now, Mike, stop that.
Hello.
I love you, Buzz.
All right.
I love you, Buzz.
Thank you, sir.
I love you, Buzz.
All right, get out of here.
Hey, nobody has commented seriously on my team yet.
Don and Mike, well.
You ask for it and you'll get what you don't want.
Yeah, that's true.
Lisa's got the pick. She's going to kick all you guys' butts.
Who?
Lisa.
Lisa.
Another vote for Lisa.
Does this mean my team sucks?
Don and Mike, no.
Yeah.
But what are these dopes know? These are dopes that are listening to our stupid radio show.
I like to get the feedback. I like to talk to the small people.
Don and Mike.
Anything can happen.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What about Edgerrin James?
Taken.
Charlie took him.
Charlie got
him. Did he? Charlie, you the man.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Hello, Don, on my show.
How you doing, Radio Gods? I definitely think that nobody has said anything about Norman's picks. I think his picks are great.
Johnny Norman.
Johnny there Norman.
You there you go.
Sure. Some love for Johnny Norman.
Thank you.
Hello, Don, on my show.
Hello. I'm not a fan of any particular team, but I really like Mike's selection, that big tight end out of Miami. My sources who have scouted him, Jeremy Shockey, he's just going to be phenomenal. I think he'll be the surprise pick of the draft.
Well, thank you, Ken. I appreciate that, and thanks for calling in.
Where'd you get those?
Beatrice, I guess.
Hello. Hello.
Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I think Mike O'Meara has a great team.
Thank you very much. Who's your favorite player on my team?
Jeremy Shockey. He's going to light up. He's going to light up the NFL.
Oh, everybody's paying attention.
Did you name anyone else on the team besides that?
Can I name? Nah.
Hello, Donna. Mike.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, I think depending on injuries, there's like five teams that could win this.
Which ones?
Yeah.
Incidentally, did we mention the names of our teams? I don't think I really spent a little bit of time,
as did I,
picking the name of my team. Mm-hmm. And you, Don, I have to compliment you on your helmet design.
Yeah, I already went to the website and did the helmet.
Yeah, me
oh, really?
Too.
I'm the DAs.
The DAs?
Fantastic. Dumbasses.
I'm the anchors.
I'm the TCB.
Oh, TCB.
And it's not pluralized. It's that new modern way where you just do mine, the TCB.
Mine was not an original idea. I went with the Sea Dogs.
That's dead.
Did you spell out the word?
Sea Dogs.
Did you spell out the...
No, it'll be C,
the letter C.
Dogs.
Bart, you have a team name?
Team Meathead.
Team Meathead, Charlie?
I hadn't thought of one. I don't know yet.
Lily? How about Big Black?
Big Black?
D.
Oh, Big Black. Yummy. No, I'm...
Yummy.
I'm the princesses, and my colors are purple and gold. And a crown is my logo.
Okay.
Purple and gold.
Oh, and Buzz, you are the...
The anchors.
The anchors.
I have an anchor
Johnny,
on my
what's
helmet.
Your name? What's your name?
Carcass.
Carcass.
The carcass.
Charlie, you've had time to think now.
Little men in the boat.
Wow. When we come back, the all-important second half of the draft right after this. Oh, and we don't have a burper yet.
No, they did not return.
No, we didn't... We were not able to hook up with our latest celebrity burper yet, so be the 100th caller now. What are you doing? Bart, what is Uncle Mike doing?
He's stroking the vodka bottle.
Yes, I am, Bart.
As he often does.
Yes, I am. Be the 100th caller, and we'll give you something right now. Dial recklessly, you animals. Good luck.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
God damn it, Eddie, it's not to me. Hey, it's my shoulder. I hit my shoulder when I hit the gym floor.
It feels like it's full of gravel.
Well, it's always felt like it was full of gravel. Now, come on, give me a B12 shot. That's what I want. Are you messing with my knee?
Hey, how you doing, baby?
All right, Dell, you gonna get a shot?
Oh, no shots for me, Turkey. I can't stand needles.
Hey, you got a master of the technology of this game.
Hey, how do you do that, man? Take all those pills and shots, man. It does terrible things to your body.
Oh. You last long enough, you'll realize the only way to survive is the pills and the shots.
Not me, Turkey. I got respect for my body.
You'll get past that.
The Don and Mike Show.
The most electrifying man in sports entertainment, Don Geronimo and Mike O'Meara.
All right, just ahead of a call number 100. There we go. Hi, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, hi, how you doing? I guess I'm the 100th caller.
Yeah, who's this?
This is Rick.
Rick, where are you from?
From Stafford.
Rick, here is my son, Bart, to tell you what you want. Marty.
Won a pair of tickets to see Ozfest 2002 featuring Ozzy Osbourne, which has been rescheduled at Nissan Pavilion for this Thursday. Tickets are available at all Ticketmaster locations and online at cc.com.
Beautiful read.
Okay.
It's in the jeans.
There you go. He's a natural.
Thank you. Hold on. Hold on, please. And now back to the 2002 Don and Mike Fantasy Draft. I heard... through the grapevine, mm-hmm. that Buzz mm-hmm. was very upset outside.
Yes.
Are you really upset?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. Well, because I know I'm not doing well, you know, as I expected. Actually, I'm doing worse than I expected.
As Senator John Warner once told me, Buzz, it doesn't amount to a hill of warm spit.
There you go.
You approach it like that, it just doesn't matter.
I'll work on that.
And at the halfway point,
uh-huh.
regardless of how I'm criticized by my friends or by the listeners, I was showing everybody I am dumb enough to work up mock drafts.
And you've gotten everybody you wanted except for
except one or two. Except for Shockey.
Who?
Shut up. You know, if I hadn't told you yesterday about Jeremy Shockey,
right,
you would not have. He could have walked in the studio today, pulled his pants down, taken a dump, and you would have said, interesting fella.
That is not correct, and I'm going to show you. All the players that I draft, if they're available, if I get to the position, are highlighted in red. Now, look at my little sheet there. Jeremy Shockey is the highest-rated tight end in my thing. So I actually, when I was ready to draft a tight end, I would have picked him regardless of our discussion yesterday.
Really?
And also, he's a New York Giant, and I knew of him, you know, and that when we were talking about him.
What number does he wear?
I have no idea.
Where do you go to school?
Miami.
Good guess.
One of the callers.
No, I'm giving it to you.
One of the callers said it? I didn't hear the call.
I'm just giving you the business. Oh, that's right. A caller said he went to Miami.
Wouldn't have known.
Okay. You don't listen to the callers.
Don't. No, not really.
They're small.
Yes.
Back to the draft. We are more than halfway through as we now start the ninth round.
And I'm really lost. I don't expect to,
Official spokesman of the stupid,
right.
Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
And on the clock is Buzz J. Gurdonly.
Was Corey Dillon taken earlier? If not, he's my next pick. Okay. Eddie George, then.
He's gone, too.
All right. Then Curtis Martin.
He's gone.
All right. Warwick Dunn.
He's available.
Warwick Dunn. Thank God for that.
Warwick Dunn.
Yeah.
All right, to me personally, James Thrash, Eagles. Now to Bart.
I'll take the Bucks defense and special teams.
Good pick. Uncle Mike.
We have a minute, correct?
With a zero-tolerance policy for everything. The Don and Mike Show.
You need it.
Yeah, I do.
I do.
See, Buzz, don't feel bad. Even you didn't need a minute. I mean, you had some guys who had already been picked, but...
Did it all in 15 seconds.
You were there, you were ready.
Yes.
Feel good, feel positive.
Okay. I'm going to take the Tampa Bay defense.
I just took them.
I'm sorry, I'll take the Cleveland defense.
That was not a gag. That was not a joke. And we go to Lily. Tampa Bay.
He just took it.
Yeah, like 10 seconds before you did.
Damn it, it's tough to keep track. Starting to get really crazy.
So many names.
Lily.
Byron Chamberlain.
Byron Chamberlain, tight end for the Vikings. And that means John Norman.
Put me on the clock.
Johnny.
Byron who?
Chamberlain.
Oh.
Johnny.
You know, my overall top 200, I thought I was going to be just able to line out the names and they'd be gone. And you guys are picking people.
We're ruining it for you, aren't we? Not everyone is using your cheat sheet.
Johnny.
Since there's been a run on tight ends, I will take...
What's that?
Frank Wycheck.
Frank Wycheck, good pick. What was that, Bernie?
What?
What'd you say to Uncle Mike? Okay, what'd you say to him?
He said, not everyone's using a cheat sheet. I said, didn't you tell me you went on the internet and got a cheat sheet today?
Oh, yes, for a couple of positions.
Okay, now.
Who's your defense?
Cleveland.
Sorry, I forgot.
Who's your...
Damn.
I'll honor the fact that he's your son.
Thank you.
There you go. I know that gets you mad.
Thank you.
All right.
But remember, we had to talk today.
Yeah.
I know.
I told him. I said, watch it with Uncle Mike today.
Be careful, okay?
Robbie?
Tiki Barber.
That's a good pick,
Rob. Tiki Barber. And that means we go now to...
Gonzalez?
Carlos Broyhill for two picks in a row.
Jerry Rice and Terrence Mathis.
Both good picks. And...
Great picks, great television.
Curtis Terrence Mathis,
of course. Your left.
Back to Rob.
Curtis Mathis.
That's a great high five.
Back to Rob.
Great TV.
Fine TV.
It's a good TV. Mike is bombed.
Poor soul.
Rob.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Where the hell is my overall Jesus?
Rob.
Deuce McAllister.
Little Deuce Coop, you don't know. You don't know what I...
And then back to Johnny Norman.
Jeff Wilkins.
Jeff Wilkins, place kicker.
And then Lily. Lily?
Yeah.
Lisa, you're on the clock.
Charlie, we're doing a radio show, and if you're going to just talk
Bart?
The whole time, share with the rest.
What are you talking to Charlie about?
I'll tell you.
Okay.
Are they already making a trade?
No. I had asked Charlie, if I could have a printout of his sheet, and he said sure. So he picked Mathis, and I'm looking on the thing, and I can't find it either. And he said no, it won't be on yours because I took it off before I printed you out a copy because I didn't want you to take him.
Oh,
uh-huh.
There you go.
That is so cruel.
Look at Mike. Look at Mike now.
How's everybody doing?
You're so funny. Oh, all right. You're going to add a little mix to that.
We're almost out of mix, everybody.
Oh, dear.
Ooh, scary time.
Lily, who are you picking?
Rob, thanks. Okay.
Lisa.
Yeah. Hi.
Serious.
David Akers.
David Green Akers.
Kicker.
To
Mike. Good for
Miguel
you.
O'Mara.
Peerless Price.
Quick pick. Two, Damian Bart.
Eric Moulds.
Nope. Eric Moulds, gone. Don't disappoint me, boy.
I won't. Thank you.
Father.
Father. That's like, what's the
father.
Cartoon?
Father.
When Sylvester the cat has a little kid.
Oh, that's right, father.
Little cat.
Marty.
I'll take Frank Wycheck.
No, he is off the board.
Televisions by Curtis Mathis.
These televisions are fine now.
Tim Couch.
Tim Couch, available. That would be to me.
Tim Couch Potato.
To me personally, and I will go with...
You're out of time.
No, that was too quick.
I know.
I will go. I will go with Trent Green. To Buzz.
Finally, a quarterback.
Is wide receiver Tim Brown still available?
It was just taken.
Okay, then Chris right. Chambers. Chris Chambers, then.
Running back. Wide receiver, Miami.
Mm-hmm.
And you have another pick.
Oh, okay. Let's make it the Redskins defense, please.
Okay. To moi. Give me. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. Yeah, Sebastian Bach. Janikowski.
Position? Kicker.
Kicker. To Bart.
John Hong.
Kicker. Jets.
Mm-hmm.
To Mike.
Has Michael Bennett been taken?
Yes.
Sorry, gang.
I told you to cross him off.
Yeah.
Forgive me, what did Bart just draft? What kicker?
John Hall.
Garrison Hurst.
Ooh. Okay, you got him. Lisa.
Sorry.
Lily.
Travis Henry.
To John Norman.
Hate to break out the rookies early, but Clinton Portis.
Who?
Clinton Portis. He's running back for the Denver Broncos.
Right. Clinton Portis from the Denver Broncos. And Robbie, you are on the clock. Clinton Portis. Although, wouldn't Orlando's Gary start before Clinton Portis?
He's not been getting the carries in training camp. They've been giving all the...
They moved Mike Anderson to fullback, right?
Yeah. And Terrell Davis might as well just be dead.
Robay?
Wide receiver, Kevin Johnson.
Kevin Johnson, the Cleveland Browns.
Rob, you sound like you were at the stadium then.
Kevin Johnson! Well, that means we go to Broyhill for two picks in a row.
Deuce Staley.
Ah!
I'll trade you.
All right.
My running back for one of your running backs.
It's all
right. What are we going to do right now?
No.
No, I don't want to. I don't want to, Charlie. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
It is okay, isn't it?
It'll have to be.
Uh-huh.
Anything else? I have a pick to make. Stop distracting me. I'll take the Cleveland defense.
It's already gone.
I got him. I know. That's why I picked him. Okay.
Oh, you were joking. I forgot that dry sense of humor.
Yeah.
Sense of humor. So dry, it doesn't exist.
Philadelphia defense.
Philadelphia defense. The Eagles defense. And we're working our way back up now, so we go to Rob. Robe speed bump.
Adam Vinatieri.
Kicker for the Patriots.
You're going to like him, Rob. He's been always been a pleasure to have on my team. Got a lot of points from Vinatieri. Over the years, when I was... that was my Super Bowl year. He was my kicker.
Johnny Norman. Johnny Norman's up.
Excuse me.
Oh!
Johnny Norman.
I'll take San Diego's defense.
To Lili. Lee. Looking at Charlie's list.
Being helpful.
Eaton. Lee.
Got my own stuff, too.
Okay. Make your pick.
Fine, then.
All right, then, fine.
Well, then, fine.
Derek Mason.
To... Mike O'Mara.
Kerry Collins.
Hey!
Two. Bart Source.
Lavernius Coles.
Two. Moi.
Christ.
Where's all your Christing players?
Christ, you know it ain't easy.
Oh, boy, I'm as bad as everybody else. God damn it. Excuse me.
Language.
Joey Galloway.
Position?
Wide receiver.
For the Dallas Cowboys, Joey Galloway.
Two buzz for two picks in a row.
Okay, I'd like to start with kicker Olindo Mayer.
Or, as we call him, Mare.
Mare. The old gray mare. She ain't what she used to be. Tight end Todd Heap.
From the Ravens. Good pick.
It is pronounced Heap.
Yeah.
Actually, Heap.
I'll land on the other one. All right, to me, Chad Lewis. Eagles.
Hold on a second. Point of order.
What?
Well, Buzz had two picks.
Yeah,
but now it's my turn.
Back up.
Why? Where's the conflict?
I picked Derek Mason, and apparently he was already off the board with the pick from Rob earlier.
Ah, so he was.
Oops. All right, well then.
That would explain why I can't cross it off.
Then, Lisa, you can pick someone else who's not already been taken.
Sorry about that, Lisa.
How many people have picked in that time? Who's been gone?
Four or five.
You haven't missed much.
Kerry Collins, Vernius Coles, Julie Galloway.
Well, that's...
Tough ass.
It wasn't my fault. It's the commissioner's fault for not realizing.
Commissioner, what do you say?
I say I'm sorry. Have a free pick.
There you go.
Jesus Christ.
Who do you like?
No. But Lisa gets two picks now, right?
He's not available.
No.
She gets one pick, and it doesn't matter what the people after me picked, even though they should have to take theirs off the board. But that's okay.
Good.
You know, someone say that it's your responsibility to keep up as well.
You know what I forgot to bring with the Bloody Marys baseball bat?
What? There's another F-bomb being dropped.
Yeah. That's what I was looking for.
All right, Lisa, you get to make up your pick now.
On the clock, 60 seconds.
God damn it.
You take 90 seconds. You've earned it.
I don't think that's right.
I'm commissioner.
Commissioner Gordon.
How was that second one I made for you?
A little stronger.
Hey.
Like a tomato martini. Like someone poured a glass of vodka and held a tomato over it.
How is yours, compadre?
I am sick of the Diet Coke this round.
Oh, you are?
Look how full that glass is.
Well, that's no fun.
I'm sorry. I have to drive, Mike.
I understand.
And I have to drive this.
Yes, I know. You have to drive the car.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You have to pilot our jet. Me, I'm riding along, navigating. And we're lost
Lisa.
Today.
Yeah, Lisa.
What?
Come on.
Come on now.
God damn, that's why you shouldn't have girls in these things. Really? A guy would just pick like that.
And I got
Jesus.
One.
Jesus. 60
come on.
More seconds.
Johnny Morton.
I think he's off the board.
Nope.
He's not. He's not?
Are you sure?
Is everybody sure?
Yes.
Pretty all sure. Right.
Wide receiver.
That was really, really, really not nice.
To Mike.
Lisa, I...
Or Bart.
I've done.
Who's that? Oh, it's Bart. Bart's mm-hmm. pick. Santana Moss. That's because you're queer for the J-E-T-S.
Just.
Uncle Mike.
Question for Moss.
Let's go with Corin Robinson.
Seattle Seahawks. And hey, guess where we're back to?
Where?
Lisa.
Well, my entire groove has been thrown.
Oh, she's been thrown.
Call Stella.
Oh, I'm
get
saying.
Your groove back. Maybe she can help you find your groove.
She really liked that joke, huh?
Fred Taylor.
Fred B.
Fred T.
Hey, Freddie's always ready. John Norman.
Thank you.
Johnny Norman. Now watch, Lisa. Watch how a man does this.
Oh, okay.
John Norman. Come on, don't let me down. You fag.
Oh, man, come on.
Armani, it's not a Tuma.
Not Armani, it's Armani.
Whatever.
Armani.
Whatever.
Whatever.
Robe.
Rob scrambling. Hold on a second.
Come on, Rob!
But you feel Lisa, you don't hear me complaining.
Come on, you're holding us up.
Exactly.
Say it like the girls of the Dallas Cowboy cheerleading.
Never miss a jump slant.
Come on, Rob!
Who are you taking, Rob?
I'm taking my time.
Flag.
You're just moving on. Don't forget about me after I've been gone.
Rob?
Yes?
And I take what I find. I don't want no one.
Shall we move past this?
Receiver Marty Booker.
Marty Booker.
Marty with a party.
Marty Booker, not mm-hmm. Booger.
Booker.
And we go to Carlos Broyhill for two back-to-back picks.
Kevin Johnson and Wesley Walls.
Kevin Johnson is gone.
Okay. Look, he gets held up. He picks four.
That's because John probably has him.
No.
No? Well, I do want Wesley Walls.
Okay, and?
What did you do?
Yes, I do. Yeah, da-da. Charles?
What's up?
J.J. Stokes.
J.J. J.J.J. To John Norman again.
To Rob.
You trade a pick to Rob?
No.
Oh, no.
No, it's Rob's.
Oh, Rob, I'm sorry.
All right.
Rob's pick.
Sorry.
Come on
Rob
now.
A. Rob
Come on
a.
now.
Can we have vodka every day?
Robe.
What makes you think I have any interest in it at all?
Smelling my belly button.
My belly button.
Button. Button.
Button.
My dog's going to take the panties off the stuffed animal. Rob.
Terrell Davis.
Terrell Davis.
Can you say broken?
Dumb. Now, John.
Oh,
When do I get to go again?
Pretty soon.
When do I get to go again? I didn't go yet. I want to go.
Should have gone in the last break.
John Norman.
I didn't have to go then.
I'll take your favorite player, Don, and I'll take Mark Brunell.
Quarterback.
Sucks ass.
He's the worst.
Freddie Jones.
Hey, way to go, Lisa.
Wow.
Way to go, Lisa. Way to go, Lisa earned. Freddie Jones, tight end for the Cardinals. To Mike.
Dorsey's leavens.
To Bartio.
Anthony Beck.
Another Jets.
Go figure.
To moi.
Or who'd you pick?
Anthony Beck. Tight end.
Anthony what?
Beck.
How do you pronounce it?
Beck.
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 What is it? T-H-E-C-T-T-Y? What is it?
Beck.
B-E-T-H.
C-E-T-H-T.
Becked.
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 Yeah.
Becked.
Becked.
S? Like Vanderjacked.
Becked.
Kevin Barlow.
Barlow.
49ers, running back.
That's deep.
No, it's not. He's going to get 1,000 yards this year.
And it's deep, baby. Deep.
Buzz, two picks in a row.
My last running back pick, Michael Pittman, Bob's brother.
I was taken.
Oh, okay. Mike Alstott, then.
All right, good pick.
And my next pick will be, if it's not taken, Kevin Johnson, the wide receiver. It is. All right. Jimmy Smith. It's like roll call. Is Derek Alexander here? Okay. How about...
hold on. Is Derek Alexander available?
Available.
He's available? Then yeah. Derek Alexander it is.
Derek Alexander.
Thank goodness.
All right. To me. To moi.
Christ.
Time.
You know it ain't easy.
Time's up.
Miami Dolphins defense.
Excellent pick, Don. Who wants some flapjacks right now?
To Bart.
Jets defense.
Jets D. To Uncle Mike.
I will take Chris Chambers.
Miami. Good pick.
Who's been taken?
That's why he's a good pick.
Buzzed it?
Yep.
How about that? Daryl Jackson.
Position?
He's all yours.
Wide receiver.
To Lisa. No pressure.
I'm not feeling any.
Come on, Fabulous Moolah.
New England defense.
To John Norman. Are we almost done?
What?
Yeah, just about.
How many rounds we got left?
I think after this one
and one more.
And one more.
Mm-hmm. Did I mention I think this vodka is a really good idea?
John, that's it. Really time?
Is it really time? I'll take Emmett.
Emmett Smith.
Emmett.
To Robay. See, now Rob has the double job of writing down all the picks and keeping his own picks. Rob, speed bump.
This will shock and amaze you, but the Dallas defense.
Dallas defense. Carlos Broyhill, as we begin the final round, two in a row. He's so funny. He's like me. He's really taking it serious.
Oh, yeah. You got to do it very
serious.
He's
laughing because he's rubbing his head against the microphone.
Charlie?
His last two picks are important. I don't get any more after this.
Yeah,
right. Right.
And then we'll
Can we all
done.
Get two more picks?
Nope, everybody gets one more after Charlie.
I've misdrafted.
Amazingly, Mike so... Still does not have a quarterback.
I am so
Okay.
I need a kicker, a tight end, and a defense. I have one of each.
One pick.
Yes.
I'll take John Carney.
Carney.
Position?
Kicker.
Kicker.
And the San Francisco defense.
All right. To Robe as we wind up the draft. There are two picks there. John Carney and who else? Charlie?
San Francisco.
San Francisco defense. Rob.
Nice fella, good fella, Brett Conway.
Brett Conway, Redskins kicker to Johnny Norman.
Down the audio trail.
Giants defense.
To Lisa.
Why do I always go last?
You're not last.
I am. I'm last, Don.
No, you're not. There are other people. Bart's after you. I'm after you. Buzz is after you.
I'm last, Don.
Lisa.
Ryan Longwell.
Green Bay kicker.
Longwell.
And now, Mike, spotlight on you.
Jeff Wilkins. Taken.
Took him gone.
Long gone.
Okay, well, I didn't know. There's a lot of people picked him.
He's like kicker from the Rams.
Has the Green Bay defense been taken?
Buzz. Yeah. Don't you remember when we laughed at Buzz?
No. Who's laughing now?
This is the
now.
Part where it's all just crap.
Byron Chamberlain.
Gone.
Jesus Christ.
Do you want me to make
Chad the... Lewis.
Gone. Do you want me to make the pick for you?
No. San Francisco defense has been taken. Dallas defense has been taken.
Hey, Ken Dilger.
John Carney.
Just taken. You really going to run out of time?
Seattle's defense.
Just got it in. Bart.
Martin Gramatica.
You are going to
be mine.
Best.
Your love you, son. Dad.
Even though you're my son, God, he was my pick.
Mm-hmm. I know. I looked on your cheat sheet.
Mine too.
Did you really? Are you kidding? Did you really look on my cheat sheet?
Dad, rat. Am I done picking?
Yeah. You rat. All right then. Oh Christ! You know nobody good left. Mm. Nobody good left. Paul Edinger.
Position?
Kicker. Bears. And finally, Buzz.
I'm guessing Jason Elam is already taken.
Yep.
Oh, all right, I was afraid of that.
I took him way back when.
Matt Stover.
Also, there you go.
There you go.
No, all right. He's available. And Matt ladies Stover. And gentlemen, that. The 2002 draft for the Don and Mike League, which is officially called on CBS Sportsline.
Buzz picks first.
Buzz has the first pick.
Buzz has the first pick.
Buzz has the first pick.
That is the name of our league.
Barring any tedium, can I real quick run down the teams and make sure we're in agreement with who everyone has drafted?
Please.
Okay, Don, for you, I have Kurt Warner, Trent Green.
At the quarterback, two quarterbacks.
Place kicker, Sebastian Janikowski and Paul Edinger.
Yes.
At running back, Michael Pittman, Kevin Barlow.
Right.
At tight end, I have Bubba Franks.
And Chad Lewis.
That'll be the one I missed. Sorry about that.
From the Eagles.
Defense, St. Louis and the Dolphins.
Right.
And your receiver core, Torrey Holt, Isaac Bruce, Ed McCaffrey, Keenan McCardell, James Thrash, and Joey Galloway.
You got it.
Cool. Buzz.
That is a winning freaking team. I don't care what anybody says. That is a winning freaking team.
Buzz, your quarterback.
Plane goes down.
I have Drew Bledsoe and Michael Vick.
Right.
Place kickers, Orlando Moore and Matt Stover.
Mare.
I like to pronounce it the way the owner does. running backs, Marshall Faulk, Stephen Davis, Warwick Dunn, Mike Allstott.
Mm-hmm.
Tight ends, Ernie Conwell and Todd Heat.
Right.
Team defense, Packers and the Redskins. And wide receivers, Terry Glenn, Daryl Jackson, Chris Chambers, and Derek Alexander.
Exactly.
Cool.
Those are the anchors.
Bart Soares at quarterback. Rich Gannon, Jake Plummer, and Tim Couch. Place kickers, John Hall and Martin Gramatica. Running
Martin,
back.
Martin Gramatica.
Is it really Martin?
Yes.
God.
Football players. Yeah.
Running backs. Amon Green and
not
Bennett.
Better.
M. Bennett, whoever that is. Michael Bennett. Sure. Tight ends. Marcus Pollard and Anthony Becht. Team defense, Tampa Bay and the Jets, and your receivers, David Boston, Tim Brown, Plaxico Burress, Lavernius Coles, and Santana Moss.
Nice draft.
Thank you.
Not Santana Dotson, though.
No.
Okay.
He's on IR.
He has a bad heel.
Mike O'Mara.
Brett Favre, Jay Fiddler, and Kerry Mason?
Collins.
What did I write? Jesus.
Kerry Mason.
You know, it'd be funnier if he spelled Collins with a K. Place kicker, Jason Elam. Running back, Sean Alexander, Anthony Thomas, Garrison Hurst, and Dorsey Levins.
Yes.
Tight end, Jeremy Shockey.
Mm-hmm.
Nice draft on that. Team defense, Cleveland and Seattle. And your receivers, Dwayne Bates, Hines Ward, Peerless Price, Corin Robinson, and Daryl Jackson.
There you go. A couple of young guys in there. They're going to have a great year.
Yeah.
This is the sleeper team, ladies and gentlemen, that's actually going to win the league this year. I'd like you all to remember I said this.
Mm-hmm.
And the Red Sox are not going to the playoffs.
Who's next, Rob?
Team Lisa Herndon. And the commissioner would like to extend an official apology to Team Lisa Herndon. Jeff Garcia, Steve McNair at quarterback, David Akers and Ryan Longwell, Priest Holmes, Corey Dillon, Travis Henry, and Fred Taylor, tight ends Byron Chamberlain, Freddie Jones, Pittsburgh and New England defense, and wide receivers Terrell Owens, Joe Horn, Jimmy Smith, and Johnny Morton. Good enough. Team John Norman, Donovan McNabb, Aaron Brooks, and Mark Brunell at quarterback, place kicker Jeff Wilkins, running backs Ricky Williams, someone named Tomlinson with a first name I couldn't spell.
Damian.
Tomlinson.
You better get those names right, Buster.
I'll check it online.
Who are you?
I'm Marcus Dawkinson.
Eddie George, Clinton Portis, and Emmett Smith.
Clinton Portis.
I'm sorry.
Sharpen your pencil, Buster Brown.
Bone, this is Norm Peterson.
Tight end Frank Wycheck, team defense San Diego and the Giants, and the wide receivers Keyshawn Johnson, Eric Molds, Troy Brown, and Amani Toomer.
You're on your game today there, Buster.
Team Rob Spiewak, with many injured people and some people that might not even play this year. Dante Culpepper and Brian Greasy, place kickers Adam Vinatieri, who Mike says was highly recommended.
Yes.
Brett Conway, running backs Curtis Martin, Tiki Barber, Deuce McAllister, and Terrell Davis.
Right.
Tight ends Tony Gonzalez, not yet signed, and Shannon Sharp. Team defense Chicago and Dallas, and wide receivers Randy Moss, Derek Mason, Kevin Johnson, and Marty Booker.
Hey, Buzz, really?
Yes.
I think Rob has a worse team than you.
Really?
Is that possible? Rob has one guy who's holding out,
right,
and another guy,
the tight end, right, Tony Gonzalez,
and another guy, Terrell Davis, who pretty much has already announced he's retiring.
Yeah, nothing about that on the team website, by the way. I actually did some research. When I went into this, all I wanted to do was not look like an ass.
Yeah.
Well, maybe next year.
And Broyhill.
Team Broyhill, Peyton Manning and Cordell Stewart. Mike Vander Gagadagadit and John Carney, Edgerrin James, Antonio Smith. Is it Antonio?
Antoine
Smith. Jeremy Bettis, Deuce Staley.
Jerome Bettis.
What did I say, Jeremy?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you, Rob.
Thank you. Tight end Wesley Walls, defenses of Philadelphia and San Francisco, and wide receivers Marvin Harrison, Rod Smith, Rice, and Mathis.
All right,
and J.J. Stokes.
You got J.J. Stokes? All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it.
May the best team win. It's going to be a long season, and, of course, you're going to hear all about it. And we hope that at home we could have helped you draft your fantasy team by paying attention to us. If you're writing some of these selections down, hopefully you're going to have a strong season in your fantasy league at home.
Now, believe it or not, there are tons of people who want to debate the choices.
Excellent.
All right.
Fine,
and,
whatever.
I know we should break first,
yeah,
and then we will come back and debate the choices, and I am ready for your accolades. I am ready for you to massage my brain. I am ready, because I am telling you now.
You said this last year, too.
No, but hear me now, Charlie.
He says it every year.
Right. On August 14th, but unlike the Red Sox bets, occasionally I come through.
Right.
This team will be the winner this year.
Okay, you said that when you had all of the Rams last time, and what happened?
I went 15-1.
And I beat you in the final.
Oh, God. I am willing to put
you
money
up. You are a juggernaut,
up,
but I am a dynasty.
Oh.
Subtle difference.
I was a juggernaut.
Yes, you were.
And gentlemen, look over here, because you're looking...
You're not going to pay attention.
...at a sleeper.
Right. No, yeah. You'll sleep, right?
Hey, you're a sleeper, Mike. That's right.
That's right.
No, I'm not planning on spending as much time out on the golf course. I'm going to be in bars this year watching the game.
Yeah, there you go.
No, I S you not, so I will be paying attention this year. You'll be drunk in the bars not knowing what happened.
No, I can be drunk and know what happens. You know that.
I know.
Obviously, I feel great about my team. Charlie feels great about his. Bart, how do you feel about your team?
Pretty good.
Pretty good. John Norman.
I think I did okay.
Lily.
Yo.
Yo, how do you think you did?
So-so, the princesses will hold their own.
How about you, Robe?
Well, as I said, I ended up looking like an ass.
And Buzz?
I don't know.
All right, we'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
I was nervous. I had fears of him maybe being gay. So I decided that I would get him involved in every sport there was available.
The Don and Mike Show.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
You never miss a jump split. No matter what. You didn't drop your palms together. You don't count wrong. You're still walking on your heels. It almost looks just like you have weak ankles. Pose on count one. That's right. Just a lack of thinking. Jump split down.
Good day to you, sir. I said good day.
Good day.
The Don and Mike Show.
Mike, did you slide that screen my way just a little bit? And Joe Arden here, there's no need to put five people on the screen who want to say the same thing. That's right, Joe. Apparently there was a discrepancy in the draft.
Uh-oh.
Bonzo.
Yeah, hey, Don and Mike.
Hi, Bonzo.
Mike, you picked the same guy that Buzz picked a couple of rounds ago, Daryl Jackson.
Oh, my. Rob, do you still have your big board?
I do, as a matter of fact. Hold on.
Boy, you know, it's amazing that people are paying this close attention.
Yeah.
That might have been, I threw all my stuff away. So, I mean, I'll make
already.
It up. I mean, that's like my fourth or fifth receiver. You know, everybody's getting a little too uptight about this.
Yeah.
You've had so much to drink. Yeah.
Not really. not when you really consider, you know, me.
Right.
You know, you're talking about...
For the normal human...
This would be a quiet evening.
Wow.
This would be bedtime.
Okay.
All right.
Rob?
Looking at this orderly chart, I don't know how an error could have happened, but what was the player in question? Daryl Jackson. Well, Mike has it. And so does Buzz.
Yes. There you go. Who picked him first?
Buzz did, so Mike, you are, you can pick another wide receiver. Buzz, Mike picked him on the last round.
Right, Mike?
No, I didn't.
Rob Gardner.
The last it's the last wide receiver that you picked.
Mike, here you go. I'll give you some choices.
All right.
Wide receiver. Let me go to my list. Second.
That sucks. That really sucks.
I'm sorry, Mike.
Rob, you had a lot. I'm not going to blame you because you had a tremendous amount to keep track of.
Mike.
And you had to pick. That's almost impossible.
You could choose from.
I know if anyone did that, they'd pick, like, injured guys and holding out.
Rod Gardner, the Redskins.
Done.
Lucian Muhammad.
Rod Gardner, the Redskins.
Rod Gardner.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I believe I may have come out ahead in that.
There you go.
Passing offense, fantastic.
Thank you, my friend.
All right, take it easy.
No fuss, no. Boy, really? I didn't think he was available. Good.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
Hey, can I ask a big favor of you?
Yeah.
I love Mike, love him to death. He for me, he makes the show. He kills me. But would it be too much to ask to let the man drink every day?
He does.
I mean, on the show.
Sir, let me you in on my secret. Either before or from the night after, there's always a bit of alcohol in my system.
All right.
Playing around, and I will let you in on a secret. Wednesday is happy day.
Happy day.
In the O'Mara house.
Welcome.
All right.
So thank you, and I appreciate your kind words, sir.
Thank you, Mike.
I bid you adieu.
All right. Good day, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
What a wonderful call. What a wonderful call.
There's the log.
So funny. So bombed. So funny. No, not by normal standards.
No.
Not by a mortal man standards.
No,
are you bombed?
Yeah, I didn't have a big breakfast this morning.
I had tomatoes for breakfast. Liquid tomato. we didn't bring another bottle.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, Buzz is kind of into it, too.
Very much so.
Rob, did you finish yours yet?
More than you know.
The fire department came and put tape up around it.
I couldn't get drunk. My kid was here.
You can leave a message if you like.
I know. I can't get a hold of my wife. I got to tell you, the discussion we had. Oh, more calls? Hi. Oops. Don and Mike. Hello. Well, never mind. Those people just dropped off. The discussion we had last night in my home.
Yes.
I was out of my mind about the draft.
Sure.
You really do get into it.
I really do. And I came down and I showed her this piece of paper. It says, I've got the mock draft. I said, and if it falls out like this, I'm going to be out of my mind happy. And as it turns out, I ended up getting 7 of the first 8 picks that I had wanted.
Which is pretty strong when you're doing a fantasy draft. That's pretty good.
I was discussing this with her, and she, for whatever reason, there was some show on PBS Monday night, another one of these Dominic Chopra guys, you know, one of these
Deepak Chopra,
yeah,
yes.
One of these Dr. Phil guys.
Right.
Hold on, someone wants to argue? I'd be glad to argue.
Never happens.
Put him on, bring him on.
Don.
Yeah.
You picked the Rams defense.
Yeah.
Didn't they get average like 20 points in last year?
Hey, game? Hey, douche, it's defense and special teams.
Oh, so you expect the special teams to override the crappy defense you just picked?
And the Rams defense last year?
Yeah.
Last year?
Last year.
Last year, number 4 rated.
All around?
Number 4 in the NFL.
On passing and rushing, what about points scored?
Sir, F you.
F you too.
F you.
Okay. Well, that went well.
So anyway.
What an ass.
Don and Mike, hello.
Don and Mike?
Yeah.
I want to talk to Lisa.
Hi. Well, she's back in the other room. I have to make a point to tell Philly.
Hey, this is your question.
Hold on a second, please. This is the last chance for Philly to get your entries in.
We're going
to
pick a winner very shortly.
Yes. To the Las Vegas Style Show at your house. We are going to narrow the field down to 3 contestants.
How are we
going to
do it? Are we going to do the vote thing? Or
we're just going to decide. You and I are going to decide, and then we're going to call each of the 3 people and pick the winner.
Good.
And we're going to somebody's house Friday night in Philadelphia to do a Las Vegas-style show.
Excellent.
Last chance to enter Philadelphia if you fax us information at 800-636-6410. I'm sorry, what did you want? Go ahead.
Hey, yeah, I called yesterday about offering Tom a ride up there to Philly.
I think Tom got a ride. I think he got a ride with the guy that gives us the finger.
Yeah, right. That's me.
Why didn't you identify?
Why are you calling back?
Well, Lisa says she was going to give him my number, and I have not heard anything from him.
Why don't you just wait? It's only, what is today, Wednesday?
Yeah.
And why are you calling us on the air about that?
Like I said, I want to talk to Lisa, not you guys.
Dumbass, call the business line. That's what Lisa just said in my headphones.
Yeah, you didn't want to talk to us.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
You know, we gave him a special exemption to get into that party, and I think he ought to be just a little bit nicer.
Hi, Don and Mike.
Yeah, I have a proposal for the coaches in the league here.
Yes.
Okay.
I want to try and put money down on one team against the 7 other coaches in the league.
All right, go ahead.
That the one team is gonna win the league.
All right.
I want to put $20 against each of the other coaches that Lisa's team is going to win.
Boy, Lisa has gotten the overwhelming support. Do you think it's because everybody wants to do Lisa? Do you think that's the reason?
No, I think so. It can't hurt. I can honestly say that. But no, I really think she's got a well-rounded team here.
Uh-huh.
I'll take you on that.
Okay, so I got Don.
Yeah, I'm in.
I'm in for $20. Mike's in for $20.
20 and Mike. Okay.
Now, I'll tell you, your team.
Anybody else confident?
I'll just tell you one thing. When I jump in on a bet, your odds increase like 20-fold.
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Philadelphia.
Hold on. Rob, are you in?
No, not me. My team sucks.
No, Rob's not in. All
that might be
Rob's
another reason.
Rob's got a good team, too, though.
No, Rob doesn't have a good team.
That
Hold
might
on.
Be another reason that I'm kind of dragging today is because I stayed up late last night to watch my beloved Red Sox on the West Coast.
They lose?
Yeah, they lost. They lost horribly.
Hello, Don and Mike.
I'm sorry.
Hey, I just wanted to defend your selection of the Rams defense on 2 points. Lovie Smith is their defensive coordinator. He came over from Tampa Bay, who obviously has the best defense. And
right.
Also, they score a lot of touchdowns because opposing teams are usually down in the fourth quarter.
Right.
And they force a lot of turnovers, and they get a lot of interceptions returned for touchdowns.
Thank you, my friend. Listen, my philosophy is very simple.
Fantasy football has changed the entire way that people root for people in the NFL.
I have put virtually all of my eggs in the Rams basket.
Right.
That's it. Kurt Warner, Torrey Holtz, Isaac Bruce, Rams defense, and special teams. I will live or die with them this year.
Well, and if Seattle has a decent year, I think my team will do well. But many, Seattle's got, what is it, Trent Dilfer that went down, right?
Yeah. How many Seahawks do you have?
I think I've got three.
All right. Well, then that would be your team. Roy Hill is heavily...
But then again, my running back, my starting running back is a Seahawk, and that's good that Trent Dilfer went out, right? Because they're going to go more to the running game now. No?
No.
All right, so I was just taking a guess.
And
I don't know from Adam.
Brian Hill is heavily invested in the Indianapolis Colts.
The Miami Dolphins are also. I've got two Dolphins that are significant here, gentlemen, in control.
Don and Mike, hello.
And the New York Giants.
Hello.
Sleeper.
Hello.
Hey, this is Aaron from Washington.
Hi, Aaron.
I have a question.
Yeah.
About the whole Philadelphia, Las Vegas-style show.
Yeah.
Us here in Washington also gave you good ratings, too. We're kind of taking it, don't you think?
Nope. No, you're not.
No, you got something big around the corner. We just had to move the date, and that's the we got the ratings in Philadelphia first.
Right.
And so we wanted to schedule a Las Vegas-style show for both Washington and Philly. Right.
And Baltimore.
And right. Baltimore. Because that didn't come through in Atlantic City, and we're going to have to wait, we still wanted to do something in Philadelphia, which we've never done before, and they've never had a Las Vegas-style show.
And we are going to have a Las Vegas-style show in Atlantic City for D.C., Philadelphia, and Baltimore.
We're still having that.
Yeah, and we would do one in the D.C. area.
Yeah.
You tell me a bar, a theater, an arena that we'd be allowed into to do the show, and I'll do it.
We actually stopped doing them because it was so difficult for the owners of these places. They got so much heat. In some cases, after we would leave, they would shut these people down because we'd give the people an excuse, even though we didn't do anything that wasn't just fun. And it just became prohibitive to do these things. But we know that everything springs forward from Washington. We never forget that, and don't ever think that we forget.
And we will have the Vegas show in Atlantic City, including bus service for about 100 listeners from D.C. to Atlantic City.
Awesome. You guys rock. That's for Tim.
Thank you,
my friend.
Bye-bye.
Thanks. See you later. Hello, Donna Mike. Oops. Donna Mike Show. Hello.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hi.
Hey, I'd just like to tell you that I'm pretty surprised that nobody's picking Buzz as a sleeper.
Yeah, me too. I'm, in fact, shocked.
But I'm also surprised nobody picked the Baltimore Ravens defense.
Well, okay, let's see. Who do they have left? They have Ray Lewis.
Well, that's about it.
Right. Goodbye. Goodbye. True. So, let me briefly tell you about this thing with my wife last night.
Okay.
That, and I mentioned this to her, God love her, we've got a library at our house, and I am not asking you when I say a library of self-help books.
Right.
Now, I've come to her in recent days, and I've said, since we had our last Come to Jesus meeting about 8 weeks ago,
right,
about me being jollier,
right,
have I not been jollier? And she said, yes, you've been fantastic. I said, well, then why are you sitting by yourself very pensively reading this book? And it's some book about being a better person, being one-on-one with the universe, making sure that you're doing something positive from this life into the next life.
Right.
And I said to her, I said, F that. And she said, well, now, see, I can't discuss this with you. And I said, sure you can discuss it with me. I've embraced the philosophy of living the now, that I'm going to be happy every day, and that we've got a great life, and we're going to do fine throughout this entire life. Yet you're sitting here, you know, all pensive, reading yet another self-help book about, you know, how you can better yourself. I said, what are you doing, Mike?
I'm agreeing with you.
Toasting me. I said,
hey, you know, I mean, I agree with the part about living the now.
I said to her, I said,
amen, brother.
Last night I said, I'm happy. I said, you know why I'm happy? And I pulled out this paper. I said, I just spent 2 hours doing a mock draft, and I'm happy because I think I might be able to get some of these players. I said to her last night.
How do you do that?
When we were in the middle of a...
How do you know who's going to draft what? Yeah. I mean, how does that work?
You go through and you say, with the first pick, mm-hmm. Buzz will take Marshall Faulk.
Right, right.
Second pick, I will take Kurt Warner.
You do that much work for it?
Third pick, I thought would be Peyton Manning. It wasn't. But you figure out where the quarterbacks will go, where right. the running backs will go.
Right.
And, you know, I figured with the 15th pick, I would take Torrey Holt. I did. 23rd pick, I take Isaac Bruce. Mm-hmm. I did. Mm-hmm. So anyway, blah, blah, blah. I'm going on. And I say to her, I said, have you ever considered the fact that maybe, just maybe, the people who advance into the next life are the dummies like me? The people who are happy with fantasy football.
Right.
I said, I'm not reading a self-help book about Gandhi and all this other crap. And here's another thing she said. She was talking about her friends. That she's looking introspectively because she's concerned about her friends, that she's not open enough with her friends. She does. I said, F that. I said, you're the CEO of you.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't like your friends...
That sounds like it's out of a book, too.
That's a self-help title.
No, no, but really, I meant that. I said, really, you're the CEO of you.
I like that.
If you don't like some people, don't hang out with them. Big effing deal.
Right.
Don't, you know, who cares? You don't have to be friends with everybody.
Right.
And then we had this discussion for about 30 minutes, and I said, all right, I'm going to go back up on the computer now. But just think about this. What if, in the next life, all the people are dumb, happy guys like me? And she said to me, in the next life, you will be my dog.
Wow. That's pretty heavy duty.
Ouch.
And later in the evening,
did she say it angrily?
No.
She hit you with a paper?
No, it was just... In the next life, you'll be my dog.
Hey, Buzz, you've had some vodka, too, haven't
yes,
you?
Yes, I have.
You like me a lot more chatty than you normally are.
So I came back into the living room.
You noticed that, Rob?
Yeah.
About a half hour later, uh-huh. I come back in the living room, and I said something to her like, are you in a better mood now? And she said, I'm in a fine mood now.
Fine mood.
And I said, you know what? Forget it. Because I'm the only guy who's not drunk right now doing this show.
What? No.
Never mind.
Buzz was just talking
I'm
a lot.
Focused.
Never mind. No, no, no. Buzz, you're drunk.
A little.
Mike's drunk. Rob's drunk. Yeah. No, you're drunk. Never mind.
Well, I want to know how this ends.
Never
I
mind.
Always felt that God
you know what I did yesterday?
Hateful.
What?
What?
I bought something that you're going to think is super jive, even though you don't go see the band.
What?
I bought it for convenience.
What?
Believe me when I tell you this, okay?
What?
Believe me when I tell you this, that when I go out and I do a band gig, one of the things that we do is that I talk in between a couple of songs. Now he's sitting back and he's not on the microphone. What were you saying? Go ahead.
I want to know what happened after she said you'd be a dog in the next life. Her dog.
Go ahead, guys.
No,
go ahead, Mike.
Now I can hear you on microphone.
Go ahead.
I bought me one of them microphones that attaches to your head.
And a headset mic.
It's so jive, but it's so functional.
You're like Madonna now.
I am. I never could get the microphone down there. See, he wants to comment badly. He's making a statement right now, but he wants to comment badly on this. But what did your wife say after she said she'd hit you like a dog?
She never said that.
What
didn't
else?
Say that.
No, I got the hitting part.
What?
And you don't care, and he doesn't care.
I care. I want to know.
Rob cares.
Never mind. No.
Rob, do you care?
I no, do. Definitely.
No, the listening audience
then
cares.
Then I will tell him during the commercial.
The listening audience wants to know.
No, too bad.
So how did the date end?
Well, like you'll remember.
I will.
I will.
Like you'll remember.
I will. Look, this is empty. It's going to be the bad hours of the show now coming up.
Well, you got no more to fill it back up with?
No, as I start that long road back to sobriety.
Don and Mike, hello.
So
hey, guys,
miserable.
Wonderful show.
What can we do for you?
Hey, Golden Boy, you're not going to sleep in your car tonight, are you?
No, man, don't worry about that. But listen, you know, you sound like you got a little attitude. You want to...
No, not at all. I really love you guys.
All right, go ahead. Anything else?
What, did you want to fight the guy?
Yeah, I want to fight him right now.
I don't want to fight you, Golden Boy.
Yeah, it's just the way you say, Golden Boy. It really pisses me off.
Okay, man.
Don and Mike.
Your mother.
Hello, whoa, Don and Mike.
Whoa. Don, what do you need? I'll bring it to you.
I don't need anything.
You need something. You got to fit in with these guys. It's going really well.
Don't listen to me. Somebody has to be in control of the show today.
You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right.
Somebody has to be standing here running the show today.
I get a free pass because I went out and bought all this stuff.
Yeah, right.
You know, I mean, everybody knows my problem.
Hello,
everybody knows that, you know, once I start, it's not going to stop.
Not a mic.
Hey, is this Paul Harvey? I want to know the rest of the story.
Yeah. Get out of here.
What happened, though? Seriously.
I lost my train of thought.
She was talking about you being her dog in the afterlife. And how did it end? How did the discussion end?
Here's how the story ended.
Okay.
I said, hey, honey, Mike bought one of those Madonna-like headsets.
Wow.
You're not going to believe this.
There you go. Okay.
Hello.
Touché. If she's going to beat your dog in the next life, then...
See, the listeners are drunk, too.
Another Bloody Mary.
Okay, bye-bye. Listen, Philly, we will start selecting a winner in the Las Vegas-style show at your home contest in the next break.
Yay. Very exciting.
Okay?
Ready.
What?
That sounded lucid, didn't it? I didn't sound bombed when I said that. Do I sound bombed? Do I sound like I'm a little inebriated here?
You look it.
Well, I am. There, it can be said. Let the glorious news be spread. Mike O'Mara's got a drunk head.
Clever.
Clever? Hey, okay, Rosie. And Rob, I'd like to point out your cheeks, which unfortunately you have never been able to hide the fact when you get bombed because, like, you break the vessels under your eyes.
Oh, my
goodness. Look at Rob's cheeks.
That's just a stroke.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
Hey, I want to talk to Mike about his belligerence.
My belligerence, yeah, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, Mike, this is the problem with drinkers, man. Y'all get too angry when you're drunk. I heard you trying to fight the other guy. You need to smoke some weed.
Hey, F you.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Proven wrong.
Hello.
Hey, Radio Gods, how you doing?
We're doing okay.
Wanted to tell you Linda Thompson and Joe Esposito are on Larry King this Friday night.
I saw Joe Esposito on the Today Show.
Rob and I were talking on the phone this morning watching Katie Couric down at Graceland.
Joe Esposito was on Larry King last week.
Isn't it kind of a drag to see him with Katie Couric when it's such a legitimate interview? When we have made fun of Joe Esposito for so long, and you see him sitting in the back of one of Elvis's Cadillacs, being interviewed by Katie Couric, trying to appear like the whole thing is legit.
Elvis' death day.
Yeah, and we're going to plot all the good stories with... Latter-day, I think, behavior around Graceland. Talking through bread, Elvis not giving up his flashlight, and, of course, champagne flutes full of narcotic coffee.
Love it.
Also, Mike, I wanted to ask you if you liked the Sinatra tape.
What Sinatra? Yes, I did. Yes, I'm giving a thumbs up. Rob told me to give. What tape are you talking about?
I gave you a Sinatra tape, and I gave Don the Beach Boys one.
Mm-hmm. When?
This has been about a week or two.
Hold on a second.
I never got it.
Are you covering for Rob? I'm not.
I never got the tape either.
They're in the office.
It was addressed to me, and I guess Rob opened it, right?
What?
Hey, everybody's getting on Rob right now.
Buzz is drunk, too.
They're in the office.
What happened?
I saw Cotton Pig and Todd Morgan on CNN
today. How did you send the thing along, sir?
I sent it to Buzz.
I hate being the only guy who's not drunk.
I just hate it.
I hate being the only guy who's not drunk.
I know how to fix that.
Shut up, you.
Hey, Joe.
We will be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
From the 1860s to the 1990s, he's the medicine man that will cure what ails you.
Mm, that hand looks a little swollen.
What do you mean?
This will just take me a minute. That's good doctoring.
He's Don Geronimo, Civil War surgeon.
Hello, m'lady. Can I help you?
No, I'm just waiting for a friend.
You know, your eyes do seem a little bit bloodshot.
Really?
I can fix that.
with his stovepipe hat and his black leather bag. He likes to make house calls.
Son, you look a little under the weather.
Well, my nose is runny.
Not anymore.
Don Geronimo, Civil War, Surgeon, Wednesday nights on ABC, right after Ellen.
The Don and Mike Show.
H to the Izzo, the Don and Mike Show.
Right, right. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hello, Don.
Yeah, hi.
If you don't get back to that story, I'm giving up on the show.
Well, I'll continue it tomorrow when those around me are not falling down drunk.
Well, you know, that was something you had in your control to begin with. You chose to allow it. Don't screw over the listeners because of them.
Oh, F you.
Well, F you too.
I mean, trust me, I'll come back to it tomorrow when those around me are coherent enough to follow.
All right. Let me just say one thing real quick about the fantasy football picks.
Yeah.
I think Lisa's getting picked a lot because she is a POA, but I think Bart's team's going to be the real sleeper of the group.
All right. He's glad to hear that. Hello, Don and Mike.
Thanks for calling, Nancy.
Don and Mike.
Hi, Don and Mike.
How you guys doing? It's me checking in again.
Hi there.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Okay.
I am kind of down in the dumps today, guys.
Why?
Hoping that today may be a lot of help Wednesday.
No, today is everybody except me is drunk Wednesday.
I'm kind of beat, man.
Share your story with us.
Well, I just paid my rent this morning. Rent was due.
Mm-hmm.
And I came back to a nice surprise for a college bill. And
how much?
$1,700 right now.
$1,700 bucks? One of your installment loan things?
Exactly. I have almost $900 of it.
Well,
I'm kind of like down, dude. I'm trying to find ways to get this stupid bill paid.
Yeah, that's rough.
I'm sorry, I can't do the show like this, Mike, like this. It's too funny.
You poor guy.
It's like being out with Mike when he's really drinking.
Man, does it really make you feel bad?
Yeah, dude, I value my education very much.
Yeah. And they don't tell you, they don't print out like a schedule, do they, of the student loan repayment?
Hello, Don and Mike.
Don and Mike.
Yeah.
Don, listen, all I hear when you talk is, get drunk, get over it.
We need to get you a cocktail. We do.
I can't.
We
can't do it. Don and Mike.
Just this once?
Hello.
Don.
Yeah.
Are you ready to take advantage of the services my family legal center offers?
Not this guy again.
What's he talking about?
Is this the same guy that always wants to offer counseling?
I've offered it to you a couple times, and I think from what I'm hearing, you are definitely ready. I think
you know what? I'm not going to fall into the trap of arguing with you again.
And I'm not going to fall into the trap of the same thing I always do, which is identify these guys as imposters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 21 years, my wife and I have been married. We had a funny discussion last night. That's it.
And Don, it didn't sound humorous to me.
Well, it is funny.
Tenuous.
It is funny.
How's your practice going?
It's doing well.
How's your marriage going?
It's doing as well as it can be, as well as it needs to be.
Well, I'll tell you how well mine's doing. Friggin' great.
But Don, we can offer two things. If you see it coming to a termination, or we can
count, I don't.
Or we can count.
I don't.
We
I
also don't. Offer.
I do see one thing coming to a termination.
What's that?
You on this show.
Well,
Don and Mike, hello.
I find counseling and legal services, when they seem to be related in some capacity, I find that highly unethical.
The douchebag calls all the time.
Regularly.
I argue with my wife all the time. Normal married people argue all the time.
You could have gone to the counselor I went to that kept a couple of cards right in the desk. Lawyer's cards.
And last night wasn't even an argument. Last night was me discussing with her what she wants to discuss.
Last night was me finally catching up to the show that I've been behind the curve on, the Anna Nicole Smith show. And one of the things you guys didn't communicate, really, you mentioned she was big. I had no earthly idea that she was that unbelievably fat.
Dude. Hello, Don and Mike.
Mike.
Yeah.
Hey, first of all, Lisa's picks are the best out of all of them. Never met her before, never seen a picture of her, so it's not the POA deal. But
we have pictures. We have pictures all over the web.
Wait.
So if you want to see a picture of her,
what can we do for you?
You'll get a picture of her.
And your second thing, your show is a lot better when everybody's drinking. A lot of spontaneity there from my buzz.
Yeah.
spontaneity.
I think it actually helps me.
No, I agree. I think Buzz should drink probably every day on the show.
I've heard that before.
Mike, no, I'm sorry.
God.
Put your hand down.
God damn it.
Don and Mike, hello.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
In your football contest?
This guy.
Between you is Bart, I think.
It's the big man.
Yeah. Hey, Don.
Yeah.
Tomorrow you should get drunk and they stay sober.
No, again, I can't get drunk tomorrow. Tomorrow's the Elvis show.
And he has to drive.
I'm in charge of the Elvis show tomorrow.
Are you the blind guy that calls?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, and you got the most incredible voice. Anybody ever tell you that?
You did.
You sound like a cartoon character. You have this kind of, hey, Don, I think you ought to get drunk.
Are you from Las Vegas?
No, I am now, but I was born in Kentucky.
Yeah, but you call us from Las Vegas,
yes.
Right?
Ah,
I
guess.
Yes.
Is it a congenital blindness?
I remember the guy, too.
What did you say, Mike?
Is it a congenital defect that you are blind from birth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I was a twin.
And are you a big man? I mean, I know you probably can't look at yourself in the mirror, but are you a large man?
Yeah, about 300.
300 pounds. Yeah.
And like I said, I was a twin when we were born. He died 2 days after we were born. He died.
What do you think a woman's breast looks like?
I don't know. They sure do feel good.
Here we go. Do you have any idea what a perfect vagina would look like?
No.
But it feels good.
But it does feel good. Hey, Buzz.
Yes, sir.
A little bit of weed would help you along, too, wouldn't it?
Well, I don't know. We haven't tried that yet on the show.
Are you a married guy?
Yes, I am.
Excellent.
Is she blind?
27 years.
Is she blind?
No, sir.
Wow. And she takes care of you?
Well, we take care of each other.
That's nice.
I would not trust Freda if I was blind and she wasn't.
Oh, sure you would.
No, I wouldn't. You know why? How do you know when you're talking to your wife that she... Because I know I would do this if Freda was blind and I had sight.
You'd do what you do on stage.
I would stand in front of her and talk to her.
No, that's not what you do. That's not your move.
Honey, I give her the finger and then I go like this.
No, you'd be her saying hi, dog.
That's the move when we have a blind guy in the audience where Don points to his butt. But then everybody tells the blind guy what Don did, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah,
really.
We have a lot of blind listeners to this show.
And we really, really treasure our blind listeners.
Absolutely.
Because to our blind listeners, this is television.
Oh, absolutely. It's so true.
It is television.
It's beautiful.
You're right.
It just sounded so true.
You're so drunk. Hello, Don and Mike.
So true, but I'm so enthusiastic.
Hello. Yeah.
Hey, what's up?
Hi.
Hey, the solution to Mike's drinking, I believe, is not less alcohol, it's more alcohol.
Amen.
Yeah.
Finally, a voice of reason.
Mike's bartender calling.
Hello. Hello.
Got me on hold.
Don and Mike, you're not on hold.
Turn your radio down, please.
Yo-yo. Yo-yo, dumbass, you're not on hold. Hello, stupid.
Man, these guys, man.
Hey, turn your radio down.
Stupid, hello. Hey, Snoop Doggy Dummy. Hello.
Yo-yo.
Hey. Yo.
Dumbass. There's somebody calling him a dumbass.
We're calling you a dumbass.
Hey, turn your radio.
Hold
on.
Hello?
Hello.
Puff Dummy.
Hello?
Yeah. Puff Dumbass.
Hello?
Sean Puffy Dummy.
Sean Puffy Dummy Combs.
Yeah, hello. You've been on the air.
Oh, yeah. My bad, man.
Right.
Yeah.
I forgot what the hell I was talking about.
Point.
Now you forgot what you wanted.
He's all right.
Yeah, man, you know.
How you doing?
I'm all right, man. I had a couple of left-hand cigarettes, you know.
Yeah, I got it. Is it all good?
All right.
Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah, it's all good.
What's up?
Hey, how you doing, man?
He called Buzz.
Hey, Buzz.
That's pretty good.
Hey, Buzz.
Hey, Buzz, I think you're going to win that tournament, too.
Hey, thank you.
Tournament.
Of course.
You got to believe.
The tournament. What time do we tee off?
Goodbye.
The little draft thing, man.
Yeah,
right,
you?
Right, goodbye.
Right.
Bye. Hello, Don and Mike.
Appreciate it.
Hello?
Yeah.
Don and Mike.
Right.
Well,
here we go.
Hello?
No, is this the Romanian guy from yesterday?
No, I'm not from Romania. I'm from France, actually.
Well,
from France?
I sure hope you respect this country while you're in it.
Well, that's not going to happen. So,
listen, Frenchie, I got no time for you.
There you go.
No time.
I've not been living. The French have been f***ing us.
No time for you.
That was good judgment right there.
Mm-hmm. All right, listen, we are going to get right to... Thanks, Mike.
You're welcome. You're welcome, Don.
Hey, fellas, let's sing a song. Okay, okay.
It means a lot coming from a drunk guy.
We're coming to your house.
We're coming to your house.
That was a good judgment, Don.
To your house.
Hey, I know. Somebody had to drive the car. You're just jealous.
You're goddamn right I'm jealous.
You could, you know, I wish I brought two. Then you could have just a little taste to nurse it along. You'd probably feel a little bit better and still be able to run the show. And yeah, you've run the show one time, I think.
One time.
The Sam Adams Brewery show was...
really bombed.
We were all... We were caught by surprise.
But that was a remote, and I really didn't really have to run everything.
That's correct.
I didn't.
Right. It just sounded like you
I know, but I'm not.
You didn't have any.
I'm not.
And you know what? That's empty, and that's been empty for an hour.
What bell?
So I'm coming back to Earth.
That's a testament to your talent as the poormeister.
Yeah. Well, also, I have a tolerance. Now, Buzz, on the other hand, I think he is still baked.
Too Bloody Marys. I'm all right.
Look at Rob's cheeks.
I'm all right.
Hi, Rob. All right, we're coming to your house, Philadelphia.
Yes. You like one?
Yes. Here are the new entries we've received.
Oh, very good.
For the Las Vegas-style show at your home, Friday night in Philly.
And I can't believe it's just around the corner.
Dear Don and Mike, I don't have 2.5 acres of land. I don't have a pool. I don't have a deck with a tiki bar. I live in Ridley Township, 2 minutes off I-95. I'm in a nice neighborhood with good neighbors, good-sized house, large backyard, large field next to me. My wife and I have parties up to 100 people. That's all I can offer. Good people, good friends, in a good place. Here you go, Mike.
Good people.
I just threw that on the ground.
God. Please.
Party invitation. A poem.
Oh, very good.
D-O-N. Daisy Dukes. That would be the D.
Right.
O. Oral pleasure. N. Nipples. And. A-N-D. Ass play. Nubile chicks. Dancing half naked. Mike. M-I-K-E. Moaning. Ice cold beer. Kegs, extra wine-soaked cigars.
Ooh, you ever had one of those?
Yeah, that is a P.S. Ben Salem, Pennsylvania is a crap hole with whores, TT bars, and truckers.
Sounds good. Very good.
It comes from Nikki. That might be a finalist.
Yeah, I think you put that in the finalist pile.
Then we have a follow-up to Lance's letter.
Another follow-up.
Dear Don and Mike, and this comes from Daydreams in Philadelphia, where the women wear nothing but a smile.
So this is from Lance?
This is from a strip bar on Lance's behalf. Dear Don and Mike.
And it would be Lance's third follow-up, which is very strong.
Dear Don and Mike, with regards to the Las Vegas-style show to be held in Philadelphia at Lance Weaver's house, Daydreams has dream girls that would love to be naked on the show. How many do you want? 2, 3, 4, or more. Let us know so I can be sure that they are awake, naked, and present Friday at 11 a.m. See, now Daydreams think this is going to be a radio show.
No, they don't understand it's an evening show, and that's miscommunication on Lance's part, and it puts him at a decided disadvantage.
And we have one more follow-up letter from the guy in Ben Salem, Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Dear Don and Mike, to clarify a couple of things. Don, the lactating moms is a joke. The purpose is to show you I'm a true fan of the show. Realistically, there are a couple of new moms in my neighborhood, but I don't know them well enough to ask them to come to my house, whip out their swollen teeth, and let their critters cry. 2, there is a Hooters nearby. I know the manager there. I can get some Ben Salem Hooters girls to come in the traditional tight orange pants. 3, I forgot, the kid across the street is the neighborhood pothead. That's for you, Buzz.
Oh, dear.
4, no BS. Everything else is 100% true. 5, I'm just an average listener who's flattered that you're even considering coming to my home. I wouldn't blame you if you selected another home if you were promised lots of nudity. I get the joke. 6, good luck. I know you'll make a great choice. Huh. And then he said another follow-up.
Wow, he's into it.
Donna Mike, my wife, the younger, more buxom Meg Ryan, has offered to serve you guys drinks all night in her skimpy bikini top. So you know she's 36D and firm. She heard the composition was stiff, and she wanted to sweeten the pot for me because she knows how much your show at my house would mean.
Oh, that's nice.
Please keep me in contention.
He is a finalist.
So...
Now, have we separated some of the finalists in
Here's what we're going to do right now, is separate and then make
we got to pick
calls.
Three, right? So, yeah. We haven't even done that yet. So
I think we were in agreement the very first entry we got, and we called the woman on the air, remember?
Can you read the letter?
Don and Mike, nudity, ha. We laugh at the thought. We party every weekend, consists of nudity and much more. My girlfriends can drink many men under the table. If you come to my wonderful dead-end street, I guarantee you the best Las Vegas style or any type other show you've ever been to. To make it better, at 1 o'clock, my husband's having laser eye surgery. If you come, he will see for the first time with his new eyes all the nude, lewd, rude behavior we can dish out.
That's a woman writing the letter,
yeah.
Correct?
Mm-hmm.
That's right there, that's extremely strong.
Yeah, plenty of room in the house on the street on a street to block off with no problem, and the craziest neighbors and friends you will ever meet, including my mom and dad.
That was one of the early letters. That is definitely a
finalist.
Do you agree? That's
yes.
Definitely a finalist.
Finalist. Then you have Lance. We have to put Lance as a finalist.
Lance has been tenacious.
Because, let me see, the original letter was, please select my house. I will have the most gorgeous babes within the city limits. Off-duty cops and firemen. If you supply the accessories other than the women and the house, this will be the biggest party in Philadelphia. He followed that with a letter saying, if my house is chosen, I would love to have the Don and Mike Show's greatest Philadelphia fans show up. He's willing to allow some extra listeners to come to his house.
Right.
He followed that up. Hold on a second. Got so many goddamn letters.
You got a stack of paper there.
He followed that up with another letter that I threw away saying he's sorry that the other two letters were so forceful.
Right.
But that he could come through with the goods. And then that was followed up by the letter on his behalf from the nudie bar. Mm.
So we have the letter from the lady and Lance. Those are our two finalists. We need to pick one more.
Now, we do have Bill.
Letter.
Hey, man.
Bill has a long letter. Let me see. Let me give you some of the highlights. I'm 21, and I live this life every day. I listen to your show every day, and you guys talk the best game. Why don't you back it up and let me show you what Philly is made of. Nudity is an understatement. My friends are crazy in this goddamn city. By the way, I'm a picky man when it comes to women. You will definitely not be upset. Who needs off-duty cops when your friends are the mayor? And he sent a follow-up. Donna Mike, I sent you a letter 5 minutes ago. Within that 5 minutes, I heard from news that could be the deciding factor. I spoke with my uncle, whose friend owns a strip club, and not one like cheerleaders, where you keep your bikinis on. Come to my house. I'm sure you can pull a few strings, and half the goddamn strip club will show up. I will wait for your call. P.S. If you talk S-H-I, you eat S-H-I, and I don't talk it, I walk it.
Wow.
Then we have the guy from Collegeville, Pennsylvania. His claim to fame, besides 2.5 acres and a jacuzzi with an outside deck, is the fact that he's the DJ at Philly's number one exclusive swingers club, Club Kama Sutra.
Well, that's tough.
Then we have the guy from Oak Tree Pub in Washington Township, New Jersey, who wrote a follow-up. Talk to two friends that are strippers for a well-known strip club in Philadelphia. They're going to bartend and give Mike some real good ass play. And again, he writes he'll have fresh herb for Buzz. Huh. And a Nazi armband for Rob.
I like that guy.
That's from Brian. Then we have, let me see, Tom from Ben Salem, the guy who's written more follow-ups than anybody else.
All right, well, that if he's got a good original letter, that puts him in the running.
He's the guy who had the top 10 reasons, large suburban home, central air, lactating mom, large deck, house backs up to the woods, my wife has a lot of cute friends, side deck, refrigerators, beautiful wife is looking forward to having both of you as guests in our home. Then we have Mark from Philly, who writes he can put 100 people into his... he's the guy who had the converted warehouse.
Oh, that's the guy. Well, what did his letter say?
Stop the presses. You have a winner. You have many deserving fans in Philly, but no party would be more memorable than my place. I live on the top floor of a 3,000-square-foot converted warehouse.
I love that idea.
My ceilings are 25 feet high. I have a freight elevator that opens up into my place and plenty of outlets for equipment. No neighbors besides me and tons of parking. And I have the hottest friends in Philly.
Nice.
I can fit 100 people easily into my space. And in the Philadelphia area, I don't go to the strip clubs. They come to my house. Nobody in this city can produce more naked, hot girls than me.
Finalists.
I do it on a regular basis already.
That's the, that first of all, that's in the city, correct?
Yes.
And it's the warehouse that's the
yes.
one I remember. And he's the guy that said nobody can produce more than, now it's a lofty claim.
Yes, it is.
If you commit early to my place, I can give you 20 invites to distribute to other deserving women listeners in my area who have not yet had the pleasure of meeting me.
That has to be the third finalist.
Okay.
Have you gone through all of them?
Well, we got the guy. I know we got a break, Rob. We got a guy who says he's better than the guy's house in Ben Salem. He's got no wife. He's got the pool. He's got the deck.
Meh.
We got a 15-year-old who wants to impress a 15-year-old friend.
Thank you, no.
We got the many follow-up letters from the guy in Ben Salem with the wife who looks like Meg Ryan.
I think you made a stack of three finalists there, didn't you?
I think we got them.
Yeah. We got the three.
All right, so here's where we're at.
Now, will we have any kind of interview process?
Yes, we're going to call each of these three people.
That's essential.
The three finalists are Danielle Kearney.
She's the one that wrote the letter for her husband that's having a laser eye surgery and guarantees a good time for everybody.
Lance Weaver.
And which Lance was a lot of follow-up.
Persistent. And Mark.
Mark from Mark. The heart of Philadelphia has the warehouse.
Hold on. And Nicole is on the line. She is the wife of the guy whose letter we're reading right now. Nicole, who is your husband?
My husband is Tom Duda.
Is that the one with the warehouse?
No, he's the one that has I'm the Meg Ryan lookalike.
Oh, the guy from Ben Salem.
Yes, we're both Northeast Philly kids, born and raised in Northeast Philly.
Was that one of our finalists?
No, we've not selected him a finalist, but let me ask you a question.
Sure.
Part of the Las Vegas-style show is the guarantee that there will be lots of women there who will be willing to play our games, get undressed, and win cash prizes.
Okay.
That's part of the... That's probably one of the reasons... that we didn't immediately throw your letter onto the finalist pile. Is that the type of thing you could guarantee would happen?
I think I could find some girlfriends. A lot of my girlfriends are quite buxom, and I don't think they would have a problem with participating in contests where they could win things and show off their hot bods. I don't think that would be a problem.
All right, I'm sorry. You know what? Mike is being very, very persistent today. With all the liquid courage, he's giving you a thumbs down.
I'm sure you are both lovely and classy.
Yeah.
But it sounds like you may be a little too classy for this show.
And here's another follow-up letter we've just received. Dear Don and Mike, have you seen the strippers in Philadelphia? 4 to 5 follow-up letters. Who are we convincing? My friends are ready to go, and all of the other finalists are allowed to come up. And that is from Ty.
Hey, you know, I like
that's
that.
Interesting.
Now, who is Todd?
I don't know. Ty? TG? Hold on a second.
Right.
But you know what? I like the idea, too, when we get our finalists, and even this lovely lady here and her husband, we should let her come to the Las Vegas.
That's nice.
I think everybody that sent a letter should be allowed to come.
Makes sense.
I can't find the original letter from this guy.
Do you like that, Meg Ryan?
Yeah.
I think she's gone.
No, I thought you were asking me if I liked her.
I don't call you Meg Ryan.
No, I thought you said, did you like that
no,
Meg Ryan?
You think that's a good idea? I think that would be very fair to everybody that took the time to send us the facts.
You know, we got so many letters. I can't find who's who. Jesus Christ. Well, all right. You know what? We're going to stick with Nikki.
Nikki.
Oh, what about that one? You don't like that one?
Unfortunately, not
one
enough information.
One of the Daisy Dukes, oral nipples, ass play, nubile, dancing half naked, moaning, ice cold beer in kegs.
I defer to my colleague over in the other room. Not so much.
All right. So these are the three finalists right here.
We got them?
Right here.
Excellent. And we'll have the interview process now.
Cool. Danielle, Lance, and Mark.
Very good.
We will talk to each of them and select the winner right after this.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Okay. Hi, this is Dorm Radio, D-O-R-M, broadcasting live from the Basement of the Science Building. Great.
The Don and Mike Show.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
Right, right.
Able to neutralize feminine odor. The Don and Mike Show.
All right, we are coming to your house. And we're doing it Friday night.
We're coming to your house.
One, two, three. We're coming to your house. We're
you
coming to your house.
Yeah, I'm the only
You're
one left.
Still.
I'm the only one left. I was
You're
talking about
drunk.
I was talking about it with Buzz out on the veranda.
Buzz, are you...
I had a little something to eat. I think I'm back to normal.
How about you, Robbie?
I think I'm okay.
You're okay.
We know you can...
Hi, Mike.
I believe Rob is not accurate in his assessment. It's your cheeks, Rob. It's your cheeks.
Are you still drunk, Rob?
Don't think so.
We're coming to your house.
Yeah.
We're going to pick a winner right now. We have three finalists that we have selected.
They're all solid, too. I think any one of them could be great.
And we have other people who have called in mad they're not finalists. For instance, here is Nikki, who sent the haiku, the D-O-N-A-N-D-M-I-K-E. Nikki.
Hello.
Hi, Nikki.
Hi, I'm not mad.
Oh, you're not mad?
I just wanted to know if I could still come.
Well, I think really if the winner gives us permission, I think every finalist, at least the individual and their significant other, should be able to go to the show.
Mm-hmm. You got it.
My significant other is out of town, so I can have a little fun now.
Even better.
There you go. Well, I would say Nikki's invited.
There you go, Mike.
Thank
right
you.
There. What are you looking at? That's right. Thank you, Nikki.
Okay.
Here did I become the poster person for ass play?
You became single. Here is Ty. Ty?
Don, Mike,
now,
I can't believe I'm not a finalist, dude.
Now, Ty is the guy who just sent in the letter saying the 5-point letter about strip clubs.
Right.
Right?
Exactly.
Was that you?
Yeah, I'm the one in Collinsville with the jacuzzi and the deck and strippers. Oh, not strippers, it's swingers.
Swinger. Oh, you're the guy with the swinger.
Swinger, dude.
Yeah.
Well, we had to pick three finalists.
That was strong.
Listen,
cyber hot swingers. I'm telling you.
And you'll be able to come to the show.
You'll be invited.
I'll be able to come to the show?
Yeah.
How many people can I bring? You know, it's three guys and a baby. We'll leave a baby at home.
Three guys. What the? Three guys and a baby thing. Now, let's give each of the finalists 1 minute to tell us why we should come to their home. Now, keep in mind, you know what we're looking for.
Yeah.
A party atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of girls.
Right.
Who don't mind getting naked.
Right.
To win big cash prizes.
Because really, when we do the show, when we're up there, the nudity is part of the act. So you have to participate, and we rely on our audience to do that.
Right? Now, we will be playing the Eat the Apple game.
Yeah, the new version of it?
Yes. We'll also be playing the Monica Lewinsky cigar game. We will also be playing the Nude Feud.
Very good.
Yes. We will be playing the Underwear Fashion Show.
Yeah, that's an evening right there.
We will be giving away in the thousands of dollars in cash.
Very exciting.
We will also supply a DJ and music.
Yes, and a state-of-the-art sound system.
And all the refreshments.
Right.
So all you got to do is give us the place and give us the people.
Mm-hmm.
It's our way.
Yeah, Donnie.
It's our way.
You tell them, baby.
It's our way of saying thank you for the number one ratings in Philly. Let's start with maybe the most...
So tired.
The most persistent person, Lance.
Hey, guys.
Lance sent us a letter, then a follow-up letter, then a follow-up to the follow-up, then a follow-up to the follow-up.
And that's not totally true. It was one follow-up and one call.
And then Steve sent a follow-up fax. That's all.
Well, all I know is you've been the most persistent.
Okay, Lance, you got 60 seconds to sell yourself.
And Mike is giving you the finger right now, Lance.
Okay, it got the club is not a bar. It's a gentleman's club.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here now telling us why we should come to his house on Friday night is Lance. Go.
It's a gentleman's club. Many gorgeous women. Steve wants to know if they can come naked. He knows it's an evening show. Want to know how many we need. I have a full basement, humongous yard, two-story single house, two blocks from Bill Cosby's house if we want to torment him, a bunch of off-duty police and firemen. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'd rather lose than lie. I know Danielle's heavy. And the girls from Philly are the best-looking chicks on the East Coast, so I have nothing to lose.
What do you mean Danielle is heavy? You mean the other contestants?
Correct. I know her.
Hold on. Let's bring her in on this.
Meow.
Danielle.
Hello.
Do you know this guy?
Who is it?
Lance?
No.
I know her from school, fellas. That's all.
What do you mean? What were you saying about her, Lance?
I'm saying that if you go there, you might have a surprise.
Like what? Lance, you gotta be, come on, this is it, this is go time.
I said she's heavy.
What do you mean she's heavy? Like she's fat?
Yeah. Yeah, she's not denying it, so there you go.
He's pulling out all the
stuff. I'm trying to think who Lance is. Yeah.
Where did
that? Three words. She is not denying it.
Lance is pulling out all the stops. Is Danielle one of the finalists?
Yes. Danielle's the girl who sent us the very first letter.
I called Steve. He knows it's the evening show, and he just wants to know how many women are coming, and he needs to send. The building of this club is a...
Now, Lance, will the party if
you
win
at the club or your house?
No, it's at my house.
At your house.
I'm just saying, somebody said it was a bar, and it really threw me and Steve.
All right, hold on, Lance. Hold on.
All right, Lance is a finalist.
Hold on. Here is Tom, the guy from Ben Salem. He's not a finalist. The guy who's got the Meg Ryan wife.
Yeah, and she just called.
Tom.
She did. Hey, guys, listen, the reason I'm calling is I just wanted to see if I could position myself as an alternate finalist in case your three finalists either don't satisfy you one way or another, or they don't work out. I just don't want to give up, man. I want to be the comeback kid.
I think that's valid. Yeah. You will be a number one alternate.
Either way, you and your wife will be invited to the show.
Yeah, you're coming to the show.
Hey, thanks, guys. I appreciate that. And please, if some guy like, you know, Lance starts to make fun of another fine contestant's weight and, you know, plays dirty and you decide to replace him with another finalist, you feel free to just slide me right in there.
We're not ready to do that yet.
Hold on a second. Let's go to the aforementioned Danielle, who is now going to get 60 seconds. Danielle, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Why should we come to your house? Go.
Why should you come to my house? No. Because you would have a ball. I have girlfriends who have no problem getting naked. I don't have a big house. I live in a row home. But we have a dead-end street that's plenty of room on it. And I don't know Lance. Yes, I'm three kids heavier than high school, but if he knew me in high school, I was only 115 pounds.
Baby.
So,
you were 115 in high school.
And baby.
And I didn't go to college, so school has to be high school.
Baby.
Well, Lance brought it up, and I don't approve of that at all.
Three kids later, but if he knew me from school, he's got the wrong Danielle.
So three kids.
In fact, my neighbor's peeking in work saying, you're not heavy.
You're saying you'd be able to supply lots of girls.
Sure. Not strippers, unfortunately.
Well, no, we like regular girls around.
Okay.
Rather than strippers, actually.
It doesn't matter.
That's what they are. And even mom and dad.
All right, you got it. Hold on, Danielle. Hold on a second.
Okay.
Hold on. Why so much hate for Danielle here?
I don't know. What's going on?
Not a mic.
I'm pleading my case.
Who's this?
It's Ty.
Ty?
You guys, Danielle's heavy. If you're bringing her mom and dad, I'm offering you swingers, people that we live the Las Vegas night every single weekend.
Yeah, but swingers, we've had experience with swingers before.
Swingers stink.
They're gross.
Let's go now to Mark. Our third finalist.
Anyone who's ever watched the show Real Sex,
right?
You know what swingers tend to look like.
Hey, Mark.
Yeah.
We're going to give you 60 seconds to tell us why we should come to your home. You're a finalist. Go, Mark.
Okay. Unlike these other people, I don't have to go to the strip clubs because the strip clubs are going to come to my house. I live in a converted warehouse on the top floor, and I don't live outside of Philly. I live in Center City. So you're coming to the heart of Philadelphia. I have good-looking girlfriends that are both strippers and regular girls, but the regular girls look as good as the strippers, unlike your other guests. And I got the room, I got the parking, I got the space, I got the good-looking people. Nobody's going to have a better party than you're going to have in my house.
Now, what about the amount of girls that you could supply?
What I was going to do, I can get 20, 30 girls, all of them hot, all of them gorgeous. I figured I'd give you guys a couple spots, you know, so you could, invite some other people, too.
So you'd make room for the people that are contestants that we're going to bring?
Sure, I can fit over 100 people on my plate, Ian.
Very nice.
And you'd be available Friday night?
Yes.
And you'd give a slam dunk party?
And not only that, I'm going to dangle another bone in front of you.
All right.
Okay, if you pay for her plane ticket, I happen to be very good friends with the model of the year for Playmate, Playboy model of the year, Amy Miller, and we could fly her in town and see if she has any of her Playmate friends in the area that could join the party.
I don't know about that, but hold on a second. I know that it's time for us to vote.
Time to vote, gentlemen.
Now we have three finalists. We have Mark, Danielle, and Lance.
Those are the three finalists.
We're going to ask Buzz, Mike, and myself to write a name on a piece of paper.
Who was the last guy we talked to?
Mark.
Mm-hmm.
And let's get the votes. In no particular order. May I see your card, please?
Yes. Here's my vote.
May I see your card, please? Oh, my. This looks like the stock market.
That's an M and A and R K.
Okay. It's, this looks like someone's EKG.
It does. Right.
What a coincidence.
And Buzz could be, I love unanimous decisions.
It was a grand slam.
Wow. Yeah, there was never any doubt.
No. Mark.
Hey, yes. Mark, guess what?
You win.
Lucky you. We're going to have a great time.
Lucky you.
That's the attitude, right? That is the attitude.
Mark, Philadelphia, we are going to be contacting you now. WYSP will contact you.
Okay.
Robbie, what's the start time Friday night? 8 o'clock Friday night.
Okay. All right.
We'll have Spike there with the music and the booze and the equipment. And we'll come with the money and everybody from the show. And all we ask is that you supply plenty of people ready to play the games.
No problem.
You got it.
Are you excited, okay, Mark?
I'm excited. I'm excited.
And you know,
have a great time. You're going to be talking about this party for years to come.
There you go.
All right, and
Mark, you have no problem if we invite some of the people who entered the contest?
No, just make sure they're not too ugly, okay?
Okay.
We have standards, remember?
You got it. Yes, right, that's right.
There's your winner, everybody, from Philadelphia.
Way to go, Mark. I think Mark may have been my pick from the very beginning when I heard his letter.
In the city.
I didn't hear from you guys for days, you know?
In the city. In the city of Philadelphia.
Yeah, I mean, really, we could walk to his joint. This is fantastic.
Yeah, view of the skyline. I have a view of the skyline. It's going to be beautiful.
Oh, fantastic. Wow.
All right, Mark, you're the winner. Hold on just a second. Friday night in Philly, we will be at your house for the Las Vegas Style Show as our way of saying thank you to everybody in Philly.
Now, the only
for
way
the number
could,
one ratings.
The only way it could be a disaster if Mark is a bald-faced liar.
Well, I don't think so, being as we called him at work.
And I think we ought to, we'll dial in the Playboy connection for him, too.
Well, if you want to pay for that, that's okay.
Well, it's a shame we're not going to be able to do that.
I got you on that.
Absolutely.
I think we'll do fine without the Playboy connection.
Yeah, I think so. I believe Mark is legit.
Now, let's see Danielle.
Yes.
Even though you did not win.
It's okay. Congratulations, Mark.
You are invited to the party, as is your husband.
Sounds good.
So please join us. Hold on a second.
Yep.
And let's go to Lance.
Hey, guys.
Lance, even though you didn't make it, you're invited. Bring a friend. Come on out.
All right, guys.
All right, you got it.
All right.
Bye. Lance, a little bummed out.
Lance is bummed.
Yeah, a little.
We're also going to invite Tom and his wife with the Meg Ryan boobs.
Absolutely.
From Salem.
They're all invited.
We're also going to invite TJ.
Yes.
We're also going to invite, his name is Ty, not TJ.
Ty.
We're also going to invite Brian from Washington Township, New Jersey.
Very good.
Okay. Virtually everybody who entered, I take it back. We're not going to invite this guy, John.
No.
What about Lisa, the lady whose husband is the cop?
Yeah, we'll invite
probably
her.
Invite her.
Yeah.
John. think so.
No.
Just a guy who had really just got a place.
Yeah.
The 15-year-old love to invite you. I don't think we can.
Can't do it. Not going to happen.
I don't think we can. So, yeah, these are the people who are not coming.
And they got to be 21, right? Everybody at the party has to be 21?
Right. Yeah. These are the people who are coming to the party, and Mark is the winner.
Mark, if you're listening, make sure you, you know, that little requirement, they have to be 21.
Gotcha. All right. Looking forward to it.
Yeah.
Going to be the all...
Of course, nobody's going to be at the door.
The all-Philly weekend, because we're going to, Jesus Christ, we're going to YSP,
right.
Do the show on Friday, then going to Mark's warehouse apartment on Friday night for the Las Vegas style show.
Sleep all day Saturday.
And then going to see Sammy Hagar up on stage at the Tweeter Center.
As Sammy's personal guest.
Saturday night in Philadelphia.
Going to be quite a Philadelphia weekend.
What a weekend. And then I get to come back to traffic court on Monday.
Yay!
You might remember that that 81 and a 55.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, that's what I'm coming back to on Monday.
Let's take the day.
You shut up. We'll be right back. You know, it's Wednesday, and there's one thing we haven't done yet today.
Haven't had our Prince Spaghetti.
No. We haven't had our Craig Wilson,
right.
And we'll get it right after this.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Listen, my friend. I am a supporter of the gay community. I wore a red ribbon to the Emmys. I have been to several Elton John concerts.
What does that mean?
Elton John is a gay.
The Don and Mike Show.
Don and Mike are a gay.
Don and Mike are a gay.
Don and Mike are a gay.
God loves the Don and Mike Show.
We do. I'm looking at today's been action-packed with the draft and the drinking and the winner of the Las Vegas-style show in Philly, but what do you give me that look for?
No reason.
It has been action-packed, Mike.
No reason.
But there's one thing we've not gotten to today, and of all days, today's the day we can't pass it up.
Every now and then, all I did was read the headline, but I believe we may have a gift from Mr. Wilson today.
For BUSA today, the final word by Craig Wilson.
When life gets too real, retire to the tub. Privately.
It's been an odd summer. In some areas of the country, it's been too hot. In others, it's been too wet. Children are being snatched from street corners and playgrounds with alarming regularity. A war with Iraq looms. And Anna Nicole Smith gets her own TV reality show, which scored the highest ratings ever for its network.
Maybe the world is coming to an end. Or should.
Personally, I've always felt that reality was highly overrated and have spent many years of my life trying to avoid it.
That's why I didn't peek in on the blonde and buxom Smith corner of the world last week. I did hear through office gossip that she spent much of her time looking at new homes, trying to find a bathtub large enough to accommodate her ample behind.
See what I mean? More reality than we need.
And now I read that Liza Minnelli and her new husband are going to do the same thing, opening up their front door and letting us in on their daily lives.
Do we dare step across that threshold?
I have been a fan of Liza's.
Winner.
Yeah.
Winner.
You're right.
Winner.
I have...
Total winner. Home run winner.
I have been a fan of Liza since I was old enough to know Studio 54 was not reality. And I'd still gladly pay money to hear her belt out New York, New York. But I'm not sure I need to see her fold her hubby's socks.
What is going on here?
If anything, these are times when filmy fantasy should be flourishing, not stark reality.
But even in the book world, reality reigns. Augustine Burroughs' new book, Running with Scissors, is getting rave reviews. The plot? Growing up in a family so dysfunctional that Joan Crawford would have looked like a benevolent aunt.
On the cover is a small boy with a box over his head. No wonder it's flying off the shelf.
But as my friend Deirdre points out,
and feelings like I'll never have you.
Well, I'm lucky this week, aren't I?
You won this week, yeah.
Maybe the book's success is because it's the fact that it makes the rest of us feel a whole lot better about our old childhood. Creepy Uncle Ed doesn't look so creepy anymore.
That may be. But I'll tell you this, I still don't want to see Anna Nicole Smith nibble bonbons while lounging in bed. Again. Nor do I want to see Liza clean out her husband's closet.
Oh.
Although I have to admit, that chore does have potential.
I don't know if we've ever if we've had this one this good for a long time.
I don't think so.
We're now continuing with The Final Word by Mr. Craig Wilson. The trouble with the world today is that there are no secrets left. Jackie Kennedy was so intriguing because she kept her mouth and closet door shut. It's a lesson lost, except on a rare few.
Would Katharine Hepburn take a tour of her pantry?
No. And good for her. I can hear that voice now. Get the hell out of here.
Would Queen Elizabeth gladly open up that purse of hers and show the TV cameras what's inside? No. And jolly good for her, too.
I have a faithful dog. A partner who cooks dinner every night.
He has won the... You have won the sweepstakes.
I just won the triple crown in this column today.
Absolutely.
I have a faithful dog. A partner who cooks me dinner every night. Neighbors who don't put out their garbage early.
Oh, God.
A sunflower out back that's just about ready to burst forth in all its glory.
For reality, mine is pretty good at the moment.
My bathtub fits just fine, too. But you're not going to see it.
There it is, the final word.
Oh, man.
Hi, Craig Wilson.
He's back.
You got all three. You got all three. That's really a rare trifecta.
That is just dumb luck in the way that the column falls out every week.
A partner who cooks me dinner every night.
My friend Deirdre points out. But really, no, the best was, I've been a fan of Liza since I was old enough to know what Studio 54 was reality. Jesus. Thank you, Craig.
Oh, yeah. Good job, Craig. Craig.
Thank you, Gregory.
You did us proud this week.
Oh, now it's time for Buzzy.
In a world where owning a radio was strictly forbidden,
right,
one man found a way to bring good news to his people.
Buzz.
That's me.
He made it up.
Lead story today has to be your selection of Drew Bledsoe?
No, that wouldn't be it.
What is the lead story?
Today's top story, the one good thing that'll come out of this September 11th.
Okay.
Stay tuned. For news and comments.
News and comments. Come on.
The Don and Mike Show.
That was very professional.
Let's do it.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you. Don't listen if you're fartless behind the zipper. The Don and Mike Show.
Listen, I know what Buzz is going to tell you about the news, but I'll tell you our lead story today is that Elvis is still dead.
Mm-hmm. Elvis is still dead.
So, and we will celebrate,
observe
Elvis's death on tomorrow's episode. If you've never heard one of our Elvis death day shows,
we know more about Elvis on this show than any other show.
Really, it is to die for.
Here's Radio 156. Headline news.
Now, here's Buzz with the news.
Hi, Don and Mike. Well, there is one good thing at least that will come out of September 11th this year. Even with Election Day less than a month behind that date, now both political parties say there will be no congressional ads that day. Democrats called for a moratorium today. The Republicans joined in, calling 9/11 a sacred day.
Repeat after me.
Yes.
B.
B.
F.
F.
D.
D.
I couldn't agree more. God, oh, whoop-dee-doo. Boy, aren't they special. What?
stinks.
They did it for you.
That's almost as good as Z104 announcing they're not going to play any commercials.
How is that incredible? I mean, they ought to all be voted out of office. Anybody that had anything to do with that.
Isn't there always some kind of unwritten rule anyway that you don't advertise on the day of the election?
Yeah, you don't advertise on the day of the election. I think on certain holidays you don't advertise. I mean, but it's like on the backs of the tragedy, they're trying to make people think they're being good guys. Why? Because they're pulling a few political ads.
Exactly.
Oh my God.
Martha Stewart and her stockbroker plan to blame it all on a 26-year-old brokerage assistant.
Stay cool. Stay cool.
That's her modus operandi right there.
That's the strategy that's been explained to the New York Daily News anyway. It may be a strategy of eat or be eaten, since Martha's personal assistant has started cooperating with federal investigators.
Who wants to eat Martha Stewart?
Into what would appear to be insider trading.
I'd rather be eaten.
By Martha Stewart?
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
Than have to eat Martha Stewart.
And never mind the wine.
And don't delete that out. I'm speaking literally about the Martha Stewart empire.
Scientists now say that a beer a day may keep the doctor away.
Thank you, in great health.
Yeah, fantastic. But today it's Bloody Mary's.
The Wall Street Journal is reporting on the research of a Dallas doc who says beer can lower blood pressure and cut the risk of heart disease.
Uh-huh.
The good doctor says beer is also high in B vitamins.
There you go.
Yeah, but he says it's only good for moderate drinkers. That's two a day for men, one a day for women.
Two a day. Does that mean you could drink 14 in a week?
Like on one night?
Well, I don't know if you can do it in one night, but you could have 14 in a week.
See, that's what I hate about those stories.
You'll have to ask.
Beer. Did you hear that, Marge? Delicious, frosty beer.
By the way, the doctor was hired for this research by the National Beer
Wholesalers. Here's Radio 156. Headline news.
Yo, Dad, can I have a sip of your beer?
No, son, you don't want to drink beer. That's for daddies and kids with fake IDs.
Wrestling star Stone Cold Steve Austin's turned himself into the cops in San Antonio. He's charged with beating his wife. The 36-year-old Texas native was released.
If she isn't Mrs. Austin.
He's out on $5,000 bond. His wife is a 42-year-old former beauty queen who also works with the WWE.
No, he's not retarded.
She says he beat her on the head, the back, and the leg before fleeing their home.
Okay, all right, time out,
all right.
We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Gosh, I hate to interrupt. It's all been so incredibly fascinating and entertaining and instructive. Really, the time has just flown by.
The Don and Mike Show.
Fantastical. Like a five-star BJ. The Don and Mike program.
Hi, Brian.
Fantastical.
Howdy,
Buzz.
Radio 156 headline sports. Baseball players didn't set a strike date as expected on Monday, but they may set one Friday.
Go ahead, set strike.
Well, now, hold on.
The Red Sox are playing like crap.
This is a conundrum.
Yes, it is.
That I've heard reported, as you've just said many times.
Uh-huh. A prevarication, if you will.
They did not set a strike date.
Monday, as we expected.
Yet, the headline in the Washington Post today, banner headline, sports section, says, August 30th, strike date set.
Well, that's the best guess, but they really haven't set it yet. They plan to and hope to make that decision on Friday.
Strike. But please strike.
That's the date they would pick.
I don't want an earring. Please strike.
They decide.
Strike date set. Mike buys leather vest.
Please don't go to work. Strike.
If you wear a toupee,
please stop this string of robberies.
Please keep drinking.
If you wear a toupee, get to Niles, Ohio tonight for the baseball game featuring the Class A Mahoning Valley Scrappers, because tonight is Jim Trafficant night.
Hey, what time you want to meet there, Rob?
Oh, I'm already going. I'm leaving right after the show.
And finally, guys have been arrested for driving drunk in cars, on horses, bicycles, lawnmowers, and now on a child's toy. In Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, an investigator was on his way to work this week when he spotted a man cruising down the shoulder of the street on a Fisher-Price Power Wheels. He says the 180-pound man was chugging along at 3 miles an hour, and the toy car was holding up under his weight.
Come on now,
Charlie.
Come on now.
house.
Police say the driver told him he was going to his uncle's house.
Yep, Uncle Charlie, too.
But he didn't explain why he was driving the Fisher-Price.
Get there faster.
He's been charged with public drunkenness.
Sorry.
The mother of the child who owns the toy car has decided not to press charges.
Good Bloody Mary.
I'm Buzz Burbank on the Don and Mike Show.
Thank you, Buzz.
No.
Thank you, Charlie the Clown Man.
We will see you tomorrow for the Elvis is Still Dead Show.
Yeah.
Excellent. All the tapes, all the stories.
Mm-hmm.
And congratulations to the guy that won in Philadelphia. What's
Mark.
His name?
Mark.
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 Sounds like it's going to be a great party. Mark, my friend.
Okay, we will see you tomorrow with a new episode. Good day to you, sir.
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 Can you...
Hi.
Can you?
Oh,
never mind. Okay.
Toodaloo.
Till we meet again, Sammy Davis Jr. saying, be kind, be nice, and I hope the next performer has the pleasure of having as nice an audience as you've been tonight. And let me leave you swinging.